Firstly, I was told to do this in English today. Kal main zyada Punjabi ch kita siga. I was told to do mostly in English. So please bear with me. If you want, if the organizer want me to do it in Punjabi, I'll do it in Punjabi. But mainu kya gaya siga ki angrezi zyada karna aaj. Also, the difference between yesterday and today is format de vich ki aaj na thoda ja interactive bhi karna siga. ਮੈਂ ਚਾਹਾਂਗਾ ਕਿ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਵੀ ਓਪੀਨੀਅਨਸ ਲਏ ਜਾਣ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੁਖਾਸਨ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਉੱਥੇ ਪ੍ਰਕਾਸ਼ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈਗਾ ਸੋ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰੇ ਦੇ ਪ੍ਰੋਟੋਕਾਲ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਨੇ ਅੱਜ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇਨ ਅ ਸੈਂਸ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਟ੍ਰਾਈਂਗ ਟੂ ਰਨ ਇਟ ਲਾਈਕ ਅ ਕਲਾਸ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਬਿਟ ਆਫ ਇੰਟਰੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਐਜ਼ ਵੈਲ ਸੋ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਟ੍ਰਾਈ ਟੂ ਪਾਰਟਿਸਿਪੇਟ ਇਨ ਦੈਟ ਐਂਡ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਆਈ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਨੋਟ ਐਨ ਐਕਸਪਰਟ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਇਨ ਫੈਕਟ ਮੈਂ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਵੀ ਕਿਹਾ ਸੀ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਰਿਪੀਟ ਇਟ ਟੂਡੇ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਨੋ ਐਕਸਪਰਟਸ ਇਨ ਸਿੱਖੀ You know, we, as I understand Sikhi, we are a do-it-yourself religion. We can only share what we have learned. So I don't have any final answers. I don't claim to have any final answers. And in fact, I say anyone who says to you they have final answers, run away from them. Because they're lying, in my opinion. Only final answers are from the Guru. Only Guru can give us final satisfaction in life. Everyone else can come, maybe inspire us, maybe give us more knowledge. Maybe share their own experience, but it is still not the final answer. Final answer is in Sikhi. Final answer is in Guru's way, which is not my way, your way, my father's way, your organization's way, but whatever the Guru's way is. So let's start with today's topic. Topic is Naam, and you might be wondering, why Naam? Now this is one of the few words In fact, there's a rare word in Sikh vocabulary which comes multiple times, sometimes just intellectual. So then I said, give me at least a year. I in fact made it my personal project that this is such an important thing, I better figure out, at least for myself, what Naam is. So I went to different deras. I believe in learning by experience quite a bit. I went to various subgroups. I spent a lot of time with 3HO. I looked at how Khand Kirti Jatha does it. I looked at how some sub-denominations in Taksal are doing it. I went to Buddhist meditation techniques on how do you become an observer of yourself if you have done those things. And I'm like, this is very interesting. Like, people are claiming that they know Naam, but we really need to have, I mean, Guru Sahib is discussing Naam with yogis, so we need to know how they think of Naam, how they experience Naam. And then Guru Sahib comes up with his own interpretation of Naam. So I tried to do a little bit of a justice, I won't say I did a complete justice, as to how people are practicing Naam. So it became very important for me. First I need to understand at a mental level, then I need to see how people are experiencing Naam, and maybe then I'll have some understanding of how does Naam enter me. Because basically we do all this so it can enter me, so I can get changed by Naam. So that's what I'm going to try to do with you guys today. I'm going to share what comes in Guru Granth Sahib, literally, figuratively, and in a qualification sense, what it's describing. Then I'm going to also share people I think have understood it. The authors and writers which have influenced my life. So I am biased because I'm only presenting you the ones which spoke to me. I can't give you exhaustive list of everyone what they say about it. So I'm going to share what I've learned. But to start with, And by the way, let me just put one more notice here. I'm apologizing in advance if you are going to become uncomfortable with some of the slides. Because some of us are used to doing certain things. Please don't take it as a personal attack. This is a learning exercise. So we'll try to understand things as some of the great Sikhs have understood it and what Guru Granth Sahib says about it. So whatever your way of doing it is, if it is being critiqued, please don't get upset. Because we all think we have figured out what Naam is. The only Naam eventually comes from who? And you'll see this in Guru Granth Sahib, it's very clear who actually gives you Naam. And we are not doing those things, we're doing all other things. So can I get a volunteer to read this aloud? I want some participation. Fluently and loudly, can somebody read this? Go ahead, thank you.
Naam is inspiration, not a mechanical
sadhana.
Or effort to be what one cannot be without inspiration. Yoga and its process may yield some strange accomplishment, but accomplishments, however extraordinary, do not belong to the essential beauty of the soul. It would mean a modification of the doctrines of yoga, which are condemned by all the guru with great vehemence. The Naam mantra roam by the thousands in yellow robes on the banks of the Jamuna and Ganga, even now, to no purpose. Harinder Singh, Spirit of the Sikhs.
Thank you so much. I want to focus a little bit on this. First thing in there is, Naam is an inspiration, not mechanical sadhana. If Naam is reduced to just mechanizations, that will make us machines, because that's why we invented machines. It has to inspire us. Whatever you are doing, however you are doing, it has to be inspirational. It should make you, jive gurbani chahunda, inna chaa chad jana chahida jehda naam jap riha. Ki jive vyah karan koi ja riha hunda na, jinna chaa chadya hunda, Punjabi ch kahunde addi thalle nahi lagdi. And Gurbani says the same thing. When the mind fails that level of inspiration, now you got Naam. If whatever you are doing is making you angry, making you frustrated, and it doesn't tell you how you deal with your spouse, then you're not having Naam in you. You're doing something else. Because Naam changes you. Naam inspires you. Naam makes you grand. That's one point here. Second is, if you have brought yoga into Naam, it's your prerogative, it's fine if you want to do it, but that's not Naam from a Sikhi angle, that's Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. He's the founder of Yoga Sutras, which is a religion actually. I know how Bikram Yoga is presented. I have also spent 3 years doing yogas. It might be good for what he's saying also, Professor Puran saying, it might yield some extraordinary things for you. But however extraordinary it might be, it is not Naam. So it's not, don't confuse Naam with physical accomplishment or metaphysical accomplishment. Because Naam is inspiration, not just a mechanical sadhana. And third part is, if what you are doing, you think is going to accomplish things for you, then when Guru Nanak saw thousands of people doing the same things at the banks of Ganga, how come they have not become inspired? And he's using the word, the Naam mantra roam by the thousands. Ajvi ne pehla bhi sige, then how come they have not gotten anywhere? So it's basically asking us to think about what we are doing again. That's probably the running thesis you'll see in almost every talk I do. Let's think about it. Professor Puran Singh is saying, let's think about this. What really is Naam for us? Is it inspiring? Is it a living phenomenon? Or is it a dead phenomenon? And I'm not calling this concept on purpose, because generally the word concept is being used to describe Sikhi these days. Concept is used to study dead matters. We are not dead matters. We are living people. Siddhant is, I know a lot of people use that word, but I ask you to come up with a different word. Sadi prerana ki hai, sadi ruh di khuraak ki hai, oh galla karo. Spirit-born people is that. Ruh vicho jamme hoi. Spirit vicho jamme hoi bande. So inspiration is very, very important. Just the siddhant, just the philosophy will make us dry moralists. And Pai Gurdas has written a beautiful war on it. He says that, I pray in front of the Guru so I do not become a dry moralist. And that's what most religious people are these days. They're very dry moralists. They're not inspiring personalities. So let's look at Naam from a living angle. Things which will change things now, not things which will guarantee some things in future for us, some spot in heaven we have been looking for. We're not looking for that in Sikhi. If you want that, there are other schools out there which will grant you that. Naam is about changing us now. Naam is about making us, basically celebrating our life today. Because that's what Gurus did. Naam entered them, they're celebrating. They're looking at everything in incredible attitude. The attitude which says, I do not accept defeat. In Guru Granth Sahib it says, like some of you might feel that, and all of us, you know, Guru Seva, at some point you start feeling, that man, this is very frustrating. Nobody listens to me. Yaar, main hi seva karna, mere koi meri gal nahi manda. It happens, right? Well, in Guru Granth Sahib it says, kahan kahavan ko kai kete. Because my inspiration comes from Guru Granth Sahib, I'm going to mostly talk about that. Guru Sahib is writing, there are so many people who think they are all that. And then you're not planning to, I am the thing, I'm the man, right? because I do so much seva. It says, Kahan kahavan ko kai kete, aiso jan birlo hai sevak. It's defining who does the seva. Sevak is the one who does seva. He said, there are very rare personalities who do seva. And the last part is very important. Utthe gala hi hai, jida tat hai ga na, jida odhe naal jog karda. Jog is union. Yoga means union literally. Union is about the spiritual connection. So when people say they're doing yoga just for physical exercise, one thing to keep in mind is, that's not true. Yoga is a religious thought. You can reduce it to just a gym, but it's not in its origin. That's not what Patanjali did. And Guru Sahib is saying, jida rab de naal jud janda, onu pata lagda what really is yoga. Jida rab de naal jud janda, onu pata lagda seva ki hai. So, if we are not connecting to the Vaheguru, and the, what basically I was coming at here was that there are so many of us who think, including myself, I am part of this, that I have figured out how to do service, how to do seva. And we think that we have the final answers on seva. But in the same Shabad, Guru Sahib says, the way you can tell somebody is figuring out is their attitude. And the attitude of somebody who has Naam in them is, Bura nahi sab pala hi hai re, haar nahi sab jite. That the attitude is, I'm not going to be self-defeatist. I'm not going to accept the status quo. I don't care what the world is saying. I need to be what, you know, what now is called the power of now, if you've read that book. This thing about positivity in life. Yeah? Bura nahi sab pala hi hai re. This requires a lot of thought. This requires you to live at a very different lifestyle. You see negativity, but you say, no, all's great. Everything is great. Jo hai, so hai. This attitude is what comes out of Naam. Because Naam is a living phenomenon. Naam is operating in us. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. About an hour I'll spend on this, and then we'll go into Q&A. So I want to start out with, I already talked about the inspirational quote. Etymology is, what does the word mean? For anything, we have to at least start with ki lafji matlab ki hai ga, the literal meaning ki hai ga. And then I'll start from there, I'll get into what qualifies in Sikhi, how it is presented, why should we do it, how should we do it, and those who did it, how did they do it? This is a question for me. I'll actually share an anecdote here. I was giving a lecture somewhere for college students, and one of them raised his hand and goes to me, and he asked me a how question. By the way, how questions are the toughest question. What and why is very easy to answer. That's mostly what we ask. They're trivial things. How question is very difficult to answer, because that question basically is saying, tell me how I can change myself. You have to do something now. It's not just learning, it's doing. So the question he asked me was, he goes, Veerji, how do I know that I am becoming religious? That's a very tough question. Because this requires development. This is not a statement anymore. Then I quickly thought and I said, you know, the only thing I know in Sikhi is that somebody who or he or she who feels that they are religious, they have to be completely in love. Not little bit in love, not Sunday morning 1 hour love. They have to be in love. And I also added right away with it, but I said, you know, you ask me and I'm thinking right now that most religious people I come across, they're always angry. So something is not adding up here. What we have made religion is not necessarily religion. It might be that you are more disciplined. It might be you might know more. But to be religious, including the definition of Khalsa as given by Guru Gobind Singh, the ones who we believe are operating in Naam, they're actually supposed to be very loving personalities. Hichai to prem ke chabuk maro gurbani kehti hai. That even when they see negativities, the only thing they use is love to operate. Even if they have to go in a battlefield, even when they have to kill somebody in the battlefield, they don't do it out of anger, they still do it out of love. Like Guru Hargobind Pasha deals with Pehle Khan. That's an important sakhi we need to remember. He's not fighting them because he hates it. He's fighting him because it's a battle of ideas. He's not killing him because he wants to kill him. This is a battle of ideas. He does it out of love. And if you don't know that Sakhi, let me just repeat it quickly here. And this is our history. Because I believe gurus were full of Naam, so I have to utilize their examples. Pehde Khan is his childhood friend. For whatever reason, he joins the Mughal Imperial Army, and one day on the battlefield, he comes across Guru Hargobind Sahib. Guru Hargobind Sahib, Guru is always an instructor everywhere, even in the battlefield. And he says to Pehde Khan, why don't you take the first shot? He tries, he misses. He says, up on one more time. He tries and he misses. He tries a third time, and Guru Hargobind Pacha says to him, let me show you how it's done. And he cuts his head off. You know, the next step is more important part. He gets off his horse. He picks up Pehde Khan in his arms, who's his childhood friend. And he says to Pehde Khan, it's your time to do your last kalams, the last rites, Islamic rites before you die. And Pehde Khan looks at him and says, I'm looking at you, I don't need to do it. This is religion. Where you are reminding others, you're not telling them, converting them to your thing. Ki hun tu idda kar la, marde waqt kar la, apan ya karde hain. Guru is still very clear. He says, we are fighting, it's okay. It was a battle idea, but I, you know, he picks him up in his lap. And he says, why don't you do your last rites? And then look at his response. And you know, in Islam, it's a blasphemy to say that I don't need to do my kalam, I'm looking at you, which means that you are enough for me, you are religious for me. This is what Naam people do. This is the source of Naam for us, Sikhi and Gurus. Let's come to the word Naam itself, but before I get into it, I have some questions for all of you. What does name mean in a regular sense? What does it stand for? How is it used every day? What's its purpose? I'm not asking you what is Naam in Sikhi. I'm asking you what is name. Generally, the regular translation we do is name. So to somebody tell me, what is name? What's the purpose of name? What does it stand for? What does it symbolize? Why do we use names? I like to break it to basics. Anji.
Identity.
Naam is identity. Yeah. Such as? Okay, good. So I can say the guy who is sitting there in his t-shirt with a Kesari Patka, or I can just say, what's your name?
Himmat.
Or I can say Himmat. So you'll know who I'm referring to if you know the person. So it identifies you. What else?
Recognition.
Recognition.
Recognition is part of it. What else?
Reference.
Reference point. What else?
Addressing.
Addressing someone, so reference and identification. What else?
Categorization.
Categorization, it helps us to, again, it's a reference point. It's a part of referencing. Good. What else? So we started out with the answer of identity. Basically, everything comes down to that. So if your name, you said, is Himmat, right?
Yeah.
Do you know what Himmat means?
Strong courage.
Strong and courage.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do you know that?
Dad.
Mom and dad, somebody told you.
Yeah.
Interesting. Any other volunteers? Anything else on Naam? Name, actually not Naam yet. What's name for you? What does name mean to you?
Point someone.
Hanji?
Point someone.
Pointing someone?
Yeah.
And what's your name?
My name is Savinder.
Huh?
Savinder.
Savinder. What does Savinder mean? Huh? You don't know? Okay. Your parents didn't tell you, or you never asked them? No, that's fine. Either you're smiling quite a bit. What's your name?
Just me.
Just me. What does just me mean?
Me is with the fate.
Fate?
Yeah.
Or fame?
Fate.
Fate? Okay. Just is more fame. Or you're just me. Just a friend. Alright. So just me. Who else wants to volunteer? Anji?
Naam is followed by the qualities within itself.
Naam is followed by qualities within itself. And what's your name?
Tejinder.
So you are following all the qualities of Tejinder?
Try to.
Tell us what Tejinder is.
Really, actually it's not a name relating to the Sikh culture.
It doesn't matter. We are not even talking about Sikhi yet. I just said, what's your name? Tell me what Tejinder is.
Tej is the influence and influence of Indar.
And what is Indar?
Indar is the name of God.
Well, that happens to be the name of God. What's the meaning of Indar?
King.
Just because Dashrath's son has a name Ram doesn't mean the meaning is Ram. Ram has a meaning. So what's Indar? Anyone knows what Indar is?
Your Indriya ka kashpo hota hai.
Okay, that's a creative interpretation. When we don't know, we come up with things. Nobody likes to say, I don't know, so we come up with things. Anyone knows what Indra means? There's a reason why I'm doing this exercise. Any example is what the word comes in Durvani often.
Rain.
Rain? You're very close. You're very, very close. Literal meaning. Huh? Indra happens to be one of the gods in Hindu mythology, but that's not the meaning. Indra refers to clouds. Indra is clouds. So sometimes Indra is interpreted as heavens, the things beyond clouds. We gotta know these things. It helps to know the literal meanings. It helps to know possible meanings. Then you can try to interpret. Otherwise, I just made her just me, and I don't know what I would have done with Tejinder, and Savinder doesn't know yet. And Himmat knew that he's strong because his parents told him so. What if parents told you something else? Because they lie lots of time too. Right? I'm just trying to make a point here. Sade saryaan da koi na koi na hai ga. Maybe some of us have spent time figuring out what her name is. Maybe we haven't. Maybe we were told, maybe we weren't told. And we want to figure out the name of God. Something which is much more than concrete us. It's going to require more effort. That's all I'm saying. Sanu apne naama nahi pata ajje. Apni identity hai, sanu kitni okhi lagdi hai samjhni. Pata hi nahi main kaun hai. Right? Identity was the example, the meaning you gave. Do I know my identity? What is my identity? Some will say I'm human. Some will say I'm Sikh. Some will say I'm South Asian. Some will say I'm father. Some will say I'm becoming a father. There's so many identities. Which identity? If you talk to anthropologists, they'll tell you that we really don't spend time figuring out who am I. We don't look into identity formation. Some of us, we get so worked up, we are always pushing a particular Sikh identity without understanding the identity formation. Tusi je jehda banda kuch labbi nahi reha ohnu tusi zabardasti kuch daoge, it'll have no meaning for them. That's why identity was never pushed. Identity formation was definitely there in Sikhi from day one. The fundamental questions were asked to figure out who you are. As you try to become, learn who you are, ਬੰਦਾ ਫਿਰ ਹੌਲੀ ਹੌਲੀ ਆਪਣੀ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਟੀ ਵੱਲ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਸੀ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਸਮਝ ਰਿਹਾ ਮੈਂ ਕੀ ਹੈਗਾ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਮਲਟੀਪਲ ਰੋਲਸ ਵੀ ਕਨੈਕਟ ਹੋਣੇ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਵੀ ਪਲੇ ਮਲਟੀਪਲ ਰੋਲਸ ਆਈ ਮਾਈਟ ਬੀ ਅ ਸਨ ਟੂ ਸਮਵਨ ਬਟ ਆਮ ਅ ਹਸਬੈਂਡ ਆਫ ਸਮਵਨ ਐਂਡ ਅ ਬ੍ਰਦਰ ਆਫ ਸਮਵਨ ਐਂਡ ਅ ਫਾਦਰ ਆਫ ਸਮਵਨ ਬਟ ਆਮ ਸਟਿਲ ਵਨ ਰਾਈਟ ਸੋ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਨਫਿਊਜ਼ਨ ਬਣ ਗਏ ਨਾ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂ ਗੋਡ ਇਜ਼ ਗੋਡ ਇਨ ਯੂ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂ ਓਨਲੀ ਇਨ ਸਿੱਖੀ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂ ਓਨਲੀ ਇਨ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂ ਓਨਲੀ ਇਨ ਸਿੱਖ ਵੈਲ ਵੀ ਕੈਨਟ ਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਦਿਸ ਯੈਟ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨਾਟ ਟ੍ਰਾਈਂਗ ਟੂ ਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਟੀ ਫਾਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ We want quick answer. Plate de vich rakho ek goli banao ta main kha lada sab kuch mil jave. And by the way, I know a baba who's doing this in California today. He sells so many sab goliyan. Kehnda main sari samagri rakhi te main 101 goli sab de part kite fir main odiyan goliyan banaiyan. Now he sells it. You eat it, tode 101 part ho gaye. Sukhmani sab to go. We are laughing, but you know, we all are like this. This is funny to us, but what I might do is funny to someone else. Because Gurbani says, Loka Ram Khilona Janya. We are playing with God also. We think it's a child's play. It actually is a child play from an innocence angle, but it's a bigger play. It's a game of love. And I want to come back to it. Make sure, go home and try to figure out what your name means. Asi bade bade na ikatthe kar rahe hain na, sat naam kithon samajh aaju sanu. ਅਜੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਮਝ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਅਤੇ ਜੇ ਆ ਗਿਆ ਜਨਰਲੀ ਸਪੀਕਿੰਗ ਪੀਪਲ ਆਰ ਨੇਮਡ ਅ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀ ਆਲ ਆਫ ਦੀਜ਼ ਆਰ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਆਈਡੀਆ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਦਰ ਯੋਰ ਪੇਰੈਂਟ ਰੀਵਾਈਜ਼ ਇਟ ਔਰ ਨਾਟ ਔਰ ਯੋਰ ਰਿਲੇਟਿਵਸ ਹੂ ਐਵਰ ਨੇਮਡ ਯੂ ਦੀ ਆਈਡੀਆ ਯੂਜ਼ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਦਿਸ ਵਾਜ਼ ਅ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਨਸਪੀਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਵੀ ਸੇ ਟੇਕ ਦਾ ਹੁਕਮ ਲਿਵ ਐਟ ਦ ਫਸਟ ਲੈਟਰ ਆਫ ਦ ਹੁਕਮ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਗੁਰੂ ਇਨੀਸ਼ੀਏਟਡ ਨੇਮ ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਨੇਮ ਯੂ ਕਮ ਅਪ ਵਿਦ ਹੋਪਫੁਲੀ ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਬਿਕਮ ਦੈਟ That's the quality which should come out in you. This is just our names. This is why even when somebody is born, we go to Guru and we say, please help us figure out what should we do with this child. So we ask the Guru to help us in even naming them. This is a tradition. So please pay some attention to even the basic things in Sikhi. Taiyan, you know, sadiyan ceremonies bahut ghat ne. We have very few ceremonies. We have, in fact, only have 4 events of the day. Janam te maran we have no control over. Amrit and Anand we get to decide. That's it. Everything else is cultural. These are the only 4-6 ceremonies. Well, Veerji, I can take requests on language, but we covered it before you came. So I'm sorry I can't do too much in Punjabi today. We talked about it earlier. Please don't mind. So the let me come back to this. Idea was that name has specific qualities. Name has parts of identity formation in it. Keep that in mind when we talk about Naam in Gurbani now. And here is the first thing I want to share. Well, this is a dictionary definition. And you can go figure it out from Oxford or American or any other dictionary. But it will say something like this. In that, name is a collection of sounds possessing the capacity to identify a person, place, or thing. It's your identification. And what does it include? It's a representation of an entity, personality, but I want you to pay the most attention to this. Set of character traits so as to make it recognizable and differentiable from others. Set of character traits. I haven't even introduced Gurbani yet. I'm just going by what you and I are learning. Dictionary mein chojo likha aa gaya. Kuch sanu samajh nahi aata dictionary khol de sab to pehla. Name the simple definition ch aaya jadon ikattha karke dekhde ho na phir pata lagda banda eh ya ya oda eh na. So I want to start with that premise. It's a set of character traits. Just in general sense. Now let's do word Naam. Now, this is one of the beautiful things in Guru Granth Sahib. Guru Sahib is working with multiple cultures. This is the time when there's a confrontation of Aryan civilization with Semitic civilization. Sami te Aryan ta majde si ge unna da sumel ho reya, unna da actually confrontation ho rahi hai Punjab de vich. And Guru is dealing with multiple languages, multiple cultures, multiple races, and literally there is a mixing of multiple bloods from different tribes. That's Punjab, historically. And in that confrontation, even Samuel Huntington said there was a clash of civilization in 1995, he wrote his thesis. And I'm saying that Guru Nanak Sahib actually dealt with the thesis 500 years before that. Literally, this is what was happening in Punjab. He uses the word Naam, and so did so many other gurus and bhagats. One of the most oft-repeated words, and you know what I discovered when I started looking into it even at intellectual level, the word appears in Persian, just like Naam. Word comes in Sanskrit from Naaman, and word comes in Prakrit. Prakrit is a group of old languages from which the current Punjabi comes out of. The medieval India had Prakrit and Upbhransh. If you really want to understand Gurbani, you'll have to spend time learning those languages. Punjabi, Marathi, Bengali are modern languages. Prakrit, which we naam hai ga. So I'm like, wow, this word is in all these major groups of languages which are in Punjab at the time. So which meaning does Guru is applying here? Right? Naam angreji vich assi bana lende, it's a set of characters. So look, the possible meanings. Pehli gal hai jehda name, jinnu assi kehnde hai, tera naam ki hai. ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਿ ਵੀ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਹਿੰਦੀ 'ਚ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਕਿਆ ਨਾਮ ਹੈ ਰਾਈਟ ਜਿਹਨੂੰ ਉਰਦੂ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੁਣ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਕਹਿਣਗੇ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਇਸਮੇ ਸ਼ਰੀਫ ਕੀ ਆ ਇਟਸ ਰਿਫਰਿੰਗ ਟੂ ਦ ਸੇਮ ਥਿੰਗ ਵਟ ਇਜ਼ ਯੋਰ ਨੇਮ ਸੋ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦੈਟ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਵੇ ਇਟ ਕਮਸ ਇਨ ਦੋਜ਼ ਲੈਂਗੁਏਜਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਇਨ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹ ਬੰਦੇ ਦਾ ਬੜਾ ਨਾਮ ਵਿਚ ਮੀਨਸ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਸਨ ਹੈਜ਼ ਸਰਟਨ ਰੈਪੂਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਨਾ ਜੀ ਇੱਕ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਆ ਰਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਉਹਦਾ ਬੜਾ ਨਾਮ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਸਨ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਨ ਫੇਮਸ ਸੋ ਦ ਫੇਮ ਔਰ ਆਨਰ Third meaning which comes is, this is the one you probably are some familiar with most. It also refers to Waheguru, but certain qualities of Waheguru. And I'll get into that a little later. The fourth one is related to the third one, but it's a little bit different technically. That's why I'm writing it down. It's inscribed there. It means something which is beyond vices. What is beyond vices? Something which is untouched by things which destroy us. So, but it's kind of related to third because we believe why Guru is beyond them, Guru is beyond them, that kind of idea. But technically it's a little bit different. So now you have 4 options and we are not in Guru Granth Sahib yet. In these 4-3 languages which appear in Guru Granth Sahib, the possible meanings are this. The identity of a person or entity, The reputation or behavior of the person, qualities as well as something which is beyond negativity, beyond negative potentialities, if I may call them. Yeah? Now let's look at in Gurbani. In Gurbani, the word is Naam. The other forms of word are Naamam, Naamah, and Naamah. Isari kuchi jane. The different forms of this word are Naay, Naamah, and Naam. The point I'm trying to make is Naam is same as all these three things, and it is also same as these three things. So this is a very, very common word in Gurbani. It has various forms. In linguistics, this is called, it has tatsam roop and tadbhav roop, the original form and the modified form. So point is, it comes quite regularly in Gurbani. So we really need to be spending a lot of time figuring this out, because this is very central to incredible amount of voluminousness in Guru Granth Sahib. Bahut jyada utilization ho rahi hai abhi. So my point is, ਇਹ ਸਾਰੀ ਫਾਰਮ ਵਿੱਚ ਤੇ ਇਹ ਸਾਰੀ ਫਾਰਮ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹਦੇ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲਸ ਮੈਂ ਲਿਖੇ ਨੇ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸੀ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਇਟੈਲੀਸਾਈਜ਼ ਕੀਤੇ ਨੇ ਇਹ ਆਲ ਦਿਸ ਐਟ ਲੀਸਟ ਮੀਨ ਨਾਮ ਸਮਟਾਈਮਸ ਦੇ ਹੈਵ ਮਲਟੀਪਲ ਮੀਨਿੰਗਸ ਲਾਈਕ ਨਾਇ ਕੈਨ ਆਲਸੋ ਮੀਨ ਜਸਟਿਸ ਨਿਆ ਤੋਂ ਵੀ ਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਉਹਦਾ ਬਟ ਮੋਸਟਲੀ ਇਟ ਮੀਨਸ ਨਾਮ ਬਟ ਦ ਪੁਆਇੰਟ ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਹੈਜ਼ ਸੈਵਰਲ ਫਾਰਮਸ ਇਟ ਕਮਸ ਇਨ ਓਰੀਜਨਲ ਫਾਰਮ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਕਮਸ ਇਨ ਮੋਡੀਫਾਈਡ ਫਾਰਮਸ ਤਤਸਮ ਐਂਡ ਤਦਭਵ ਰੂਪਸ ਓਕੇ ਸੋ ਲੈਟ ਮੀ ਆਸਕ ਯੂ ਐਜ਼ ਅ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ. You all have names here. There are about 100 of you sitting here. There are so many names we use to reference other people. In Guru Granth Sahib, we can have a debate about how many names show up. In Islam, they have specified that this many are the names of Vaheguru or Allah. Which name matters most? You tell me. You have so many options of names now. Which name matters most? Anyone? Hanji?
None. All same.
Well, that's different. None and all the same are two different things.
All of them refer to God.
All of them refer to God. I won't get into God, that was a previous lecture. But we'll say whatever God means. Okay? So, CG?
The one which is most important.
Well, that's what I'm asking. Which one is that?
Vaheguru.
Vaheguru? Okay, for you it's Vaheguru. Hanji?
Omkar.
Omkar, Tade layi Omkar. ਹਾਂਜੀ ਸਤ ਨਾਮ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਇੱਕ ਇੱਕ ਜਣਾ ਪਲੀਜ਼
ਸੈਟ ਆਫ ਐਟਰੀਬਿਊਟਸ
ਵਿਚ ਸੈਟ ਆਫ ਐਟਰੀਬਿਊਟਸ ਸੀ ਵੈਨ ਵੀ ਆਸਕ ਲਾਈਕ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਗੋ ਥਰੂ ਬਿਜ਼ਨਸ ਟ੍ਰੇਨਿੰਗਸ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਆਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਐਂਡ ਇਵੈਂਚੁਅਲੀ ਦੇ ਵਿਲ ਆਸਕ ਯੂ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਡੂਇੰਗ ਅ ਕ੍ਰਿਟੀਕਲ ਅਨਾਲਿਸਿਸ ਸਿਗਮਾ ਅਨਾਲਿਸਿਸ ਔਰ ਸਵਾਟ ਔਰ ਅਦਰ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਦੇ ਵਿਲ ਆਸਕ ਯੂ ਵਾਟ ਮੈਟਰਸ ਮੋਸਟ ਐਂਡ ਵਾਂਸ ਯੂ ਫਿਗਰ ਆਊਟ ਵਾਟ ਮੈਟਰਸ ਮੋਸਟ ਯੂਰ ਆਨਸਰਸ ਬਿਕਮ ਵੈਰੀ ਕਲੀਅਰ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਕਰਤਾ ਵੀ ਹੈਗਾ ਸਾਰਾ ਇੱਕ ਓਂਕਾਰ ਤੋਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਗੁਰਪ੍ਰਸਾਦ ਤੱਕ ਹੈਗਾ ਐਗਜੈਕਟਲੀ ਕਿਹੜਾ ਨਾਮ ਫਿਰ ਮੈਟਰ ਕਰਦਾ ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਸੱਚ
ਸੱਚ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਇੱਕ ਹੈਗਾ ਸਤ ਨਾਮ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਵਰਡ ਸੱਚ ਯੂਜ਼ ਕਰਦਾ ਲੈਟਸ ਟਾਕ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦੈਟ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਸਿਕਸ ਯੂਜ਼ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਡ ਵਾਟ ਡਸ ਸੱਚ ਮੀਨ ਆਪਾਂ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਐਟ ਲੀਸਟ ਨੋ ਦ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਆਈ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਟੈਲ ਮੀ ਦ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਦ ਵਰਡ ਸੱਚ ਦੈਟਸ ਦ ਇੰਟਰਪ੍ਰੀਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਮਾਈ ਫਰੈਂਡ ਐਨੀਵਨ ਨੋਜ਼ ਦ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਸੱਚ
ਅਨਚੇਂਜਿੰਗ
ਦੈਟਸ ਰਾਈਟ ਸੱਚ ਇਜ਼ ਕੰਸਟੈਂਟ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਸਦਾ ਸਥਿਰ ਰਹਿਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਵੀ ਫੀਲ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਇਜ਼ ਕੰਸਟੈਂਟ ਡਸਨਟ ਗੈਟ ਲੈਸ ਔਰ ਮੋਰ ਵੀ ਕਾਲ ਇਟ ਦ ਟਰੂਥ ਵਿਦ ਅ ਕੈਪੀਟਲ ਟੀ ਬਟ ਦੈਟਸ ਐਨ ਇੰਟਰਪ੍ਰੀਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਰੀਅਲੀ ਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਸੱਚ ਮੀਨ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਚੇਂਜਿੰਗ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਉਹ ਨਾ ਘਟੂਗਾ ਨਾ ਵਧੂਗਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਕਹਿਣ ਤੇ ਜਾਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਹਿਣ ਤੇ ਕੁਛ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਮੰਨਦੇ ਹੋ ਨਹੀਂ ਮੰਨਦੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਫਰਕ ਨਹੀਂ ਵਿਚ ਮੀਨਸ ਸਦਾ ਰਹਿਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਆਦ ਸੱਚ ਜੁਗਾਦ ਸੱਚ ਵਾਲਾ ਆਈਡੀਆ and we interpret that as being truth. So it's really important, at least understand the literal meaning. Then it can help us to figure out a lot of things about it. Okay, anyone else? What name matters most?
It doesn't really matter at all.
Does it really matter at all?
No. Because, for example, you are you as a person.
Yeah.
Whether you call it Harinder or Sukhvinder or something else, you still remain the same person.
Mm. So I am God now?
Well, in a way, yes, because God lives everywhere. God is inside you as well. You are a creation of God, so you are also a part of God.
Well, that's different than being God.
Yes.
So there are differences in these things. Oh, Anand Haq ke aasi yone kina ona ji Mansoor ne te ono suli te chadata si because he said I am God. People didn't understand what he was saying. He meant I am part of God. We have to be careful. In Gurbani also, we say Guru Arjan Pratak Har. We don't say Guru Arjan Har. There is a difference. A minute one, a semantic one. In an earlier session I said, any lawyer can tell you, every case is one on semantics. So it does matter how you refer to Vaheguru and the name. So let's think a little bit more. Anyone else?
Doesn't Vani teach us that the name is not important? Koi bole Ram Ram, koi bole Gulam.
You guys are onto something. You're smart people. Let's keep thinking. This is the thing. We are just not having enough facilitations of these things. So that sentence has the word, or it didn't have the word Naam, but it's making us think about which name really matters. So we have to start going, look at this. We have to see in Gurbani, is it this? Is it this? Is it this? Or is it this? Or is it all of it? Which one is it? That's what it will come down to. If you're only looking at the physical attribute, I'm sure you can destroy it in a minute. But that's all we are after these days. Set of traits, oh, asi gall hi nahi karde. Je sanu pata hi nahi ki rab de gun ki ne, sanu kivein pata lagu main ki bana. We rarely talk about Vaheguru kidda da. Asi kehnde oh hega bas ik hega, hun apne kam karo. Nyane nu sikhai janda hai rab ik ka yaad kar lo changi tarah. Because we are not focusing, we are focusing on physical identity only. And there people fight them. Koi kehta hai bolo, koi kehta hai bolo. So let's move on. Basically, what I was trying to get here was, according to Gurbani, and you guys already know this, and I've just translated on purpose Vaheguru because I don't want to get into which name here yet. It's basically saying there is only one name which matters most. And though that name is to be discovered, and I've again just put Satnam as Satnam, Janaki and I will translate Gita, this is the only name which matters. Kirtam Naam is a qualification. Kirtam is the one which you're able to describe also. My point of this slide is your name, my name, what Veerji was saying, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. What my reputation is, what my identity is. These are smaller identities. We never say when the river goes into ocean that the river is still in the ocean. We just say this is ocean. So the name which matters most, without going into the technical part of it yet, is Vaheguru's or God's or whatever you want to call it. Yeah? So if that's the case, I want to know how do we identify with Vaheguru versus what is the identity of Vaheguru. Basically, I'm asking, if you feel Vaheguru matters most, tell me how you identify with Vaheguru. Because basically, let's say if there is a, I don't know, pick a sports star, for example, Michael Jordan. You know, we know it's Michael Jordan, we gave a referral. How do people identify with Michael Jordan? Well, some buy the shirts he sells with his logo, some buy those 150-pound shoes. That's how we identify. So if you feel Vaheguru is most important, that identity matters most, tell me how you identify with Vaheguru. Hanji.
ਜਦੋਂ ਕੋਈ ਚੀਜ਼ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਸ੍ਰਿਸ਼ਟੀ ਦੀ ਰਚਨਾ ਨੂੰ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਪਸੰਦਾਂ ਦੀ ਦੇਖਦੇ ਕਿ ਬਾਕੀ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਪਿਚਰ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਦੀ ਬਣਾਈ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਆਟੋਮੈਟਿਕਲੀ ਸਾਰੇ ਹੱਥ ਵਿੱਚ ਦਿਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਿਕਲਦਾ ਹੈ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ
ਹਾਂਜੀ
ਮੇਰੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਨੇ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਖੂਬਸੂਰਤੀ ਨਾਲ ਬਣਾਇਆ ਹਰ ਇੱਕ ਦੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਵਸਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਸੋ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਹਿ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ
ਮਿਸਟਰ ਸੋ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਫੋਰ ਸ਼ੇਅਰਿੰਗ ਮੈਂ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਗੱਲ ਕਹੀ ਸੀ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਕੀਪ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਪਰਸਨਲ ਨਾਟ ਐਬਸਟ੍ਰੈਕਟ That sounds great, and I'm not countering it, but I want to tell me how do you identify with Vaheguru. If that identity matters most, in a daily life, nita prati di zindagi de vich, kyunki aapa advertisements dekhi de ne, jede rock star naal, jede car naal, tusi identify karde ho, phir hodi hodi paise jod de na, ki main bhi lena agli BMW. You identify like that, right? You buy a particular brand, like, main bhi ghode wali paayi hoyi hai is village. So you do something, you identify with it. I want to know, in the daily life, in the nitty-gritty daily grind, how do I identify with Vaheguru? Hanji.
Identify a trait which you aspire to become.
Yeah. In fact, that's a simple answer. You have to identify with a trait, and then you see how you're going to bring that trait within you. But my question was more, how are we doing it today? That's how we're supposed to be doing it, right? Do we do this with Vaheguru? Asi aise baith ke dekhya ki main aaj hukm sunya is hukm de vich dassya gaya ki Vaheguru meharwan hega te main apni life vich gracefulness leke aani hai. Asi karde hain ta sochde hain ta baith ke That's why ਸਾਡਾ ਰੱਬ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਰਿਸ਼ਤਾ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਜੁੜ ਰਿਹਾ। ਅਸੀਂ ਰੱਬ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਐਬਸਟ੍ਰੈਕਟ ਬਣਾ ਲਿਆ, ਉਹ ਕਿਤੇ ਬੈਠਾ ਹੈਗਾ, ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹ ਗੁਣ ਨੇ, ਬਟ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਨਹੀਂ ਲੋੜ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ। ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ, like we don't make a list, the year has come through, this is December 31st or April 15th or March 15th, whatever works for you, whether you believe in those Nanak Shai Karan or not, pick a day, pick your anniversary, pick your birthday, whatever, and do you come up with, you know, this year, I have learned that Vaheguru is gracious, I'm gonna work for next year to become graceful. That would be identifying, because that's the only way to identify according to Gurbani, where you bring the same trait what the Veerji, the Mr. Lawyer, I'm forgetting his name, has said. Yeah? So, let's talk a little bit more Gurbani here. Let's identify identities. Basically, our time is going to identify with temporary identities. We know they are temporary identities, but we spend our time and energy working with these things. Main itthe jana, main is saal vacation nahi kiti, main utthe jana, ਮੈਂ ਇਹ ਵਾਲੀ ਕਿਤਾਬ ਵੀ ਪੜ੍ਹਨੀ ਆ, ਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਇੱਥੇ ਦਾਖਲਾ ਕਰਾਉਣਾ, ਆਰ ਆਲ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਥਿੰਗਸ, ਡੋਨਟ ਮਿਸਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਮੀ, ਬਟ ਪ੍ਰਾਇਮਰੀਲੀ ਮਾਈ ਟਾਈਮ ਐਂਡ ਮਾਈ ਮਨੀ ਗੋਜ਼ ਇਨ ਟੂ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਫਾਈਂਗ ਵਿਦ ਟੈਂਪਰਰੀ ਸਟੱਫ, ਬਟ ਯੈਟ ਇੰਟਲੈਕਚੁਅਲੀ ਵੀ ਨੋ ਦ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਟੀ ਵਿਚ ਮੈਟਰਸ ਮੋਸਟ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਪਰਮਨੈਂਟ ਵਨ, ਬਟ ਮਾਈ ਟਾਈਮ ਡਸ ਨੋਟ ਗੋ ਟੂ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਫਾਈ ਵਿਦ ਦਿਸ, ਸੋ ਬੇਸਿਕਲੀ ਐਨੀਵਨ ਕੈਨ ਟੈਲ ਯੂ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋਟ ਰਾਕਟ ਸਾਇੰਸ, ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਡਨ ਦੈਟ, ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਸਟੱਫ. Wherever your time and money goes, that's what you identify with. If your time and money goes to make your house bigger, to bring your families together, to vacation, that's what you identify with. And I'm not saying don't do that. I'm saying, is there a percentage of time, 5% of your money, 10% time, that I'm actually going to go take a course in changing my habit? Because I have learned that it's very important to change my habit. I need to stop lying. And let me invest time and money in stopping the lie. That's the reality. ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਛੱਡ ਪਰ ਯਾਰ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਬਿਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਕੰਮ ਦੇ, ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਦੇ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ, ਐਵੇਂ ਕੋਰਸ ਕੁਰਸ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀ ਕਰੀ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਨੇ। But that's what we used to get trained on. ਹਰ ਜਨ ਐਸਾ ਚਾਹੀਏ ਜੈਸਾ ਹਰ ਹੀ ਹੋਏ, the devotee of Vaheguru needs to be just like Vaheguru. And how will you become like Vaheguru? By just say doing your nitname? Yes, it's very possible, but nitname could be like I do it, fatafat mari 35 minute ghatti te gaye, ek word vi yaad nahi rehnda kehda behavior change karna si, aaj utthe likhta nitname ji kur kriya aur jyo sab hi jag sri bhagwan ko bhej na payo. The whole world, I will literally say it in a crude way, the way it's written, Kur kriya, the whole world is involved, is busy in trashly behavior. And they are not working to discover Vaheguru. That's what Guru Gobind Singh Maharaj is writing. So our very action can be Kur kriya also. It's not just Hindus or Muslims. Where are we? We are doing the same things. And he writes this after observing what people are doing. So it's very important. He's not writing this in a philosophical sense. You know, the nine Savaye before that, I personally feel, I try to visualize that, how would Guru, where did Guru Gobind Singh Maharaj write this, what did he do? I feel that he is writing this when he observes, when he is 5 or 7 years old, coming from Patna to Anandpur Sahib, and Guru Tegh Bahadur Pasha has him to come there, and he is observing what people are doing. Koi putha ladak raha, rabnu land lai. Koi kehda idda khade ho, koi kehda idda baitho, koi kehda idda bolo. That's what Savaye's are. If you read up carefully, that's what he's describing. Does he react to everything? Today we start reacting to everything. Does he start reacting to, yaar tu idda na kar, tu idda na kar, tu idda kyun karda? That's what we do. We are walking around Gurdwara even doing this thing. Tu idda seva kar, tu pura case nahi takeya jae, kud ek, we are just too busy policing. But he's saying, he's observing. He says, ek rati bin ek rati ke. He says, what is happening? Their love is missing now. They're not even worth a penny. Then he moves on to other things like, look, physically what they're doing. But does he go react to everything? He's observing first. And he's observing a lot. I'm trying to make this an educational way of looking at a Savaye. Then he brings into himself what I need to do. Then he brings the community. He trains the community that how we need to change our behavior. And he starts calling them the Khalsa. The ones who changes his or her behavior and is full-time revolutionary to work on bringing Naam in them. And let me come to that idea. My point here was, we spend our time and money on these things. do it, but the, if you will, the most important one is the permanent identity of Vaheguru. Why are we not doing this? In fact, I have a more example that I want to say. Sohela word Punjabi is Hega. This means wedding song. Punjabi which wedding song is Sohela. We have a little bit of a song. Do you see Sohela in the morning? Rath no, the whole kind of part of the Haji? Saskar Vele. Now let's look at the psychology of gurus here and how it was brought into our psyche. He's saying because when you sleep at night, you don't know if you're going to get up in the morning. Right? Tahi Sandhu kya janda ki vahe guru de naal judke sao, te utke pher judo, then start doing your daily things. Because we don't know saa ame ke naa ave. Right? We don't know if we're going to get the next breath or not. Sohila, we do it when somebody dies at the funeral ceremony as well. Because look what it's doing. And it's using the marriage symbolism. He says, Guru Sahib is saying, Guru Nanak Sahib in this case, he's saying, you are connecting to the permanent identity when you marry death. Ithon tanu Sikh history samjhao ki naam japan wale kyo martyrdom di tiyar rehnde si. ਨਾਮ ਜਪਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਖੂੰਜੇ 'ਚ ਬਹਿ ਕੇ 24 ਘੰਟੇ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਨਹੀਂ ਬੋਲਦੇ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਕਰਦੇ ਸੀ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰਪੇਅਰ ਦੈਮਸੈਲਵਸ ਫੋਰ ਰਿਐਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਆਫ ਲਾਈਫ ਐਂਡ ਲੈਟਸ ਲੁੱਕ ਐਟ ਦਿਸ ਇਟ ਸੇਜ਼ ਤੁਮ ਗਾਵੋ ਮੇਰੇ ਨਿਰਭਉ ਕਾ ਸੋਹਿਲਾ ਸਿੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਵੈਡਿੰਗ ਸੌਂਗ ਵਿਚ ਵਿਲ ਮੇਕ ਯੂ ਫੀਅਰਲੈਸ ਆਪਾਂ ਪੜ੍ਹ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਰੋਜ਼ ਰਾਤ ਨੂੰ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਬਟ ਆਰ ਵੀ ਗੈਟਿੰਗ ਫੀਅਰਲੈਸ ਆਰ ਵੀ ਸਿੰਗਿੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਵੈਡਿੰਗ ਸੌਂਗ ਰਤਨ ਸਿੰਘ ਪੰਗੂ ਸੇਜ਼ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵਾਟ ਬਾਬਾ ਗੁਰਬਖਸ਼ ਸਿੰਘ ਸ਼ਹੀਦ ਸੈਂਗ He married death. Lada padke gaya si utthe darbar sab nu defend karan. Hau wari jit sohele sada sukh hoye. Look the way sukh is written. Khakhe nu ankad lag gaya, which means the ultimate happiness, the happiness. You want the happiness, then you have to sing this wedding song. Why wedding song? Wedding song vale chaya. Other day I talked about in the Grist workshop. In fact, this is where Guru says, whether you come to my physical wedding is not as important. But the day this happens, when I have married death, fearlessness, please come to my door and make sure you drop a little bit of oil. Because Punjabi custom of dropping the oil was, jad vyah karke banda ghar aunde laake hunda si apni body. Yahi hunda si na tej chode si. Udhar bulaya, deho sajna si sadiya, jo homai sahib si ume. Os vele gaya milkar paapo te. Basically, when the Sikhs start identifying with the permanent attributes of Vaheguru, which includes becoming completely fearless, we used to say, "Ye bande de vich rab aa gaya." Asi rab nu koi ai nahi hunda si jive kise ne itthon physically koi light hundi aundi dekh li. Sade dharma ch kuch nahi hega. Sade vich ehi hai ki kinna ohne daan deta. The only charity which qualifies you, doesn't mean you don't do charitable work, but in Sikhi, the real charity is Kanchan Syo Paiye Nahi Tol Man De Ram Liya Hai Bol. You, worth of gold, you will guarantee a spot in heaven. They still believe that. That's what Tahi Apne Bande Bhi Sona Hi Kaiyan Se Dekhi Jau. Jinda Sona Chada Rahe Ho, Onni Kathra De Josity Kathra Hi Hai. Guru Sahib Ne Kada Hi Chada Hai. Basically, a bribe Sigi Ranjit Singh Di to keep the priest quiet. Because of his wrongdoings. Literally it is that. It was never golden in the Guru period. But that's a separate story. The issue is, Guru Sahib is saying, you cannot get to Vaheguru by giving donation worth when you weighed yourself in gold. Ram liya hai mol. This is how I got to the goals of God. So this is basically that. In Sikhi, the permanent identity, I'm identifying with that, the permanent identity of Vaheguru, you identify with Vaheguru when you bring Vaheguru's attributes within you. And when you do that, this is where Naam comes. And let me talk about this a little bit here. First thing is, Naam in Gurbani is an active force. Naam is supposed to move you. Remember the first line, it's inspiration. Naam is not passive. Jida Naam japreya, jime bhi japreya. Jo active nahi ho raha life vich. I don't know. It might be mechanical sadhana, but not necessarily now. Why it is active? Look what Gurbani says. And you know this, it's a very popular saying in Sukhmani Bani. Naam ke tare sagle jan, naam ke tare khand brahman. Basically, everything in this world is operating in Naam. So Naam has to be an active force. Jide vich Naam aa gaya, jide vich actually Naam operate kar raha, oh ta chuk nahi sakda. Look at Guru Amar Das Padshah. He says, Anand paya meri maaye sat guru main paya. He's active. He's very active. Naam is an active force. Naam is not a shunya state of yogis. Because their goal is shunya. Jinnu sunna kehnde hain gurbani vich word aaya. Their goal is nothingness in mind. Naam is thoughtfulness in mind. That's a complete opposite. Sandhu Guru Sahib ne kithe nahi kiya ki vichar leyane band karo. Oh keh raha hai vicharan nu upjao. Vidya vichari ta paropkari. It's the opposite. Shunya says the goal is nothingness. The opposite of shunya is surat in Gurbani. Surat says the goal is thoughtfulness. Guru says, I want you to really develop what you are thinking. Now imagine how we are presenting things these days. Naam will make you active. Naam, Guru Nanak Sahib is full of Naam. He says, you have to develop everything up here. Tithya kadiya, surat, mat, man, budh. Develop every faculty of mind. Naam will make you active. Naam will make you a poet. Naam will make you a warrior. Naam will make you a writer. Naam will make you do seva. Naam will make you do simran. Naam will make you do whatever you are thinking, different things in life. Naam will not make you quiet as we present quietness. Okay? So it's a dynamic reality. It is the authentic force of life. Look at every guru. They have social challenges, political challenges, economic challenges. And they're full of Naam. And they respond to everything in life. Person with Naam in them responds thoughtfully. They are a rebel with a cause, if I may call it, not rebels without a cause. They rebelled. Guru Nanak was rebellious. That was his intrinsic nature. But he had a cause. Let's come to this. So in Sikhi, and this is where I'm particularly talking about, ajkal bada rola pa reya na kitho mile. I have been to deras. I said, you know, I was going around experimenting on Naams. I ended up with a dera, very famous dera. They had a rate list of Naam. Private Naam, this many rupees. Public Naam, this many rupees. Personal Naam, this many rupees. I'm like, what the? I mean, this is something else. And then start thinking, yeah, like Gurbani Naam, and people go in thousands. Then I start looking at Gurbani. Okay, let's say I've understood at least intellectually what Naam is. Now, how do I go get Naam? Here is the answer. First thing is, Naam kitho miluga? Naam is Niranjan Agam Agochar. I really want you guys to understand this. Niranjan is immaculate. Jinnu aam taur te pure keh dende na. Agam is unfathomable. Nobody can tell you exactly what it is. Naam is Agochar. It is beyond perceptions we have developed. So basically, if somebody is saying they are going to give you Naam, they are saying they have become immaculate, they have become unfathomable, and they have become imperceptible. Can somebody claim that today? Look what this line says. Satgur diya bujhaye. Only the Guru can give you Naam. If somebody tells you they are going to give you, even the panch pyaras tell you to repeat it, they are the agents on behalf of the Guru, they are not the Guru. That's our tradition. Guru Granth Sahib ji kaabya de jaake ek sikh uthaya janda singh, pamritdhari person who has taken khande ki ball, then five stand there, man or woman, and one stands outside the door, and they say we are operating on behalf of the Guru. If they start telling you their own things and their own preferences, they've already violated what they're doing. Because they are not the Guru. They are fulfilling a responsibility like a citizen is supposed to vote and they might get called on for a particular duty by the government. A Khalsa is supposed to be prepared to do it on behalf of the Guru. Not act as a Guru. They're two very different things. So only one who can give you Naam is Satgur Diya Bujhai. And Bujana is a very interesting word. Bujana ki hunda ji Punjabi ch? Hanji? Samajna, Labna, what else? To understand, what else? What is Bujharat? Hanji? Bujharat is a riddle. Which means you gotta figure it out.
there's something hidden from you, and you.
Bujharat is a riddle, as I said. You have to figure it out. Bujana is to solve it for yourself, to figure it out. It's one of those tendencies when you're struggling to figure out something and you eventually get it, you say, oh, I see. It's not physical seeing, it's mentally connecting. ਅਸੀਂ ਦਰਸ਼ਨ ਵੀ ਇਹੀ ਬਣਾ ਲਿਆ ਨਾ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਫਿਜ਼ੀਕਲੀ ਦੇਖਣ ਨੂੰ ਅਸੀਂ ਦਰਸ਼ਨ ਕਹਿਣ ਲੱਗੇ ਹਾਂ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ 'ਚ ਕਿਤੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ 'ਚ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਲੱਖਾਂ ਲੋਕ ਗੁਰੂ ਨੂੰ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਆ ਗੁਰੂ ਨੂੰ ਦੇਖਣ ਨਾਲ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਪੀਪਲ ਸਾਲ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਸਿੰਘ ਇਟਸ ਨਾਮ ਇਜ਼ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਵਿਚ ਹੈਪਨਸ ਬਿਟਵੀਨ ਅ ਸਿੱਖ ਐਂਡ ਅ ਗੁਰੂ ਇਫ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਐਨੀ ਵਨ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਮਿਡਲ ਇਟਸ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਐਲਸ ਦੇਰ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਅ ਰੇਟ ਲਿਸਟ ਐਜ਼ ਆਈ ਮੈਂਸ਼ਨਡ ਅਰਲੀਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਸਮਟਾਈਮਸ ਇਟਸ ਨਾਟ ਅ ਫਿਜ਼ੀਕਲ ਮੋਨਿਟਰੀ ਰੇਟ ਦੇਰ ਆਰ ਅਦਰ ਰੇਟਸ ਟੂ ਬਲੈਕਮੇਲਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦੈਮ Guilt driven life is another one. Some people tell you, Tujhe itna naam nahi japega, narka jayega. I find that amazing when we do that. Because the Gurbani I am able to understand, which is very little, it says if you go to your beloved out of fear, you've already lost it. Because we are love driven, not fear driven. Semitic tradition is fear driven. Even Aryan tradition is fear driven. Ona de devi dev te gusse hi bhare rehnde ne. ਉਹ ਸ਼ਰਾਬ ਹੀ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਦੇਖਿਓ ਦੈਟਸ ਦੇ ਰਿਲੀਜੀਅਸ ਪਰਸਨੈਲਿਟੀ ਹੁਣ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਵੀ ਉਹੀ ਕਰੀ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਬਟ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਇਟ ਸੈਜ਼ ਇਹ ਕਿਨੇ ਹੀ ਚਾਕਰੀ ਜਿਤ ਭੌ ਖਸਮ ਨਾ ਜਾਏ ਵਟ ਕਾਇੰਡ ਆਫ ਸਰਵਿਸ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਡੂਇੰਗ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਸਟਿਲ ਅਫਰੇਡ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇਨ ਆਰ ਸੈਂਸ ਇਨ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਟੋਲਡ ਟੂ ਬਿਕਮ ਫੀਅਰਲੈਸ ਗੋ ਆਊਟ ਆਫ ਲਵ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਨਾਮ ਨਾਟ ਆਊਟ ਆਫ ਫੀਅਰ ਦੈਟ ਸਮ ਹਾਊ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਗੋ ਟੂ ਹੈਲ ਔਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ ਵੈਰੀ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਸੋਰਟ ਆਫ ਅ ਪਰਸੈਪਸ਼ਨ ਬੇਸਡ ਔਨ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਓਕੇ Can I get a volunteer to read this? One person who can speak, you can't see it because they turned the lights on. I don't know what to do. Can somebody stand up in here and do it? Haji.
Okay.
Read aloud, please.
Sure. The Naam is the seed of a grain like love. The new person of the Guru is to sprout like a tree growing upward. The spirit is born person, unlike the ordinary religious. Is not tied to any past, but with the whole future. Guru Nanak impregnates the seed of Naam with himself and scatters the seeds all over. The river takes it, the wind spreads it. The seed is the Khalsa, which may be seen in its glory. People gathering on the banks of the Ganges, the Mississippi, the Thames, and the Seine will be reborn in the spirit of the Guru.
Thank you. This is from Professor Puran Singh again. I love it. I can't stress it enough. You got to pick up his books. This man understands the spirit of Sikhi. Look at how he presents Naam. Grain-like love. What is grain-like? Grains have potential. If you split a grain, if you become a split personality, you cannot grow. B.O. Beech Pat Lagai, Ab Kyo Gweda. Asa Ki Var Sindha Hi Likhya. If you yourself are not connected, if a seed is split, there is no growth. You have to keep yourself connected. Grain-like love, the new person, sprout like a tree growing upward. And you know, he said, the river takes it, the wind spreads it. This seed is the Khalsa. Now look at that Jagat Jo Japan this person. The one who lives in awareness, the one who is filled with love, the one who does not recognize anything other than the oneness. There is no other condition. He says that screen needs to be spread throughout the world. Ganga de samne, Mississippi de tode, London de river samne bhi. What is he saying? He says, our job is to grow this tree. The seed is the grain, Naam is the seed. And you know, Gurbani says it very clearly, If you are from a farming background and the land is not prepared before, you have to plow the land. That's the discipline. Before you plant the seed. And once you throw the seed, then you have to do so many other things to grow it. Tard kaya sadh kai, vich de karta biyo. Asa ki vaar chaudha. This body has to be disciplined. Is it ready to take the seed? If the body is not ready to take Naam, the seed, it's nothing's going to happen because you have to water it at the right time, you have to fertilize it at the right time, you have to pull the weeds out at the right time. That's Naam. It's serious stuff. It's not as simple as ki vaiguru repeat karta ek vari ya 10 vari ya 100 vari ya 24 paudiyan te kadke kise gurdwara ya te sari 84 katti gayi. That's what we are doing now. Naam is that potential which is supposed to make us divine like. Mantu jyot sarup hai, apna mool pachhan. I am the divine, I am part of the divine. Recognize your worth. Naam makes us worthy. Naam develops us. Naam makes us recognize the dignity in myself and how do I look at the world, the lenses to look at the world. And Professor Puran Singh is saying, this is waiting. This is the world is impregnated with it. It's waiting to explode with Naam. But why is it not exploding? We are not making Naam active. We have made Naam passive. Naam is active. Gurbani vich Naam de vichon sab kuch ho reha. Naam nu sirf jab ke side te nahi rakhna koi. It's not an idea. It's a grain potential. So let's talk about Naam in a summary sense. Few things I want to cover here are, first thing is, Naam is inseparable from Vaheguru. Vaheguru and Naam are synonymous. That's something which should be very clear by now. That's why there is no one particular identity we work with. We work with the qualities of Vaheguru. Second thing is, Naam is beyond description. Which means nobody fully understands Vaheguru. But we, if I become Nirbhav and I become a creative personality, Akalpur, I have understood few behaviors, but I can't say I got the full Naam. That's what people try to say, ki main hi dabanga, wo keh raha hai ki mainu sab kuch pata de. No. Whatever you know about Vaheguru, whatever, God, Vaheguru, Allah, jo bhi kehna chahne ho, whatever you know about him or her or whatever you feel it is, whatever quality you can take out of Vaheguru, when that quality enters you and it becomes habitual, Vaheguru is entering you. Naam is entering. So if anyone says, mainu nahi kuch pata lag raha, a simple message hai ga. Judi bhi cheez tuhanu pata ki ye rabbi guna, devi guna hai ga, divine quality hai. When it comes and enters us, when it operates us, we are becoming Vaheguru-like. We are becoming Harja. That's Naam. And don't think it is not in your potential. It is definitely in everyone's potential. This is a departure from other world religions in Sikhi. Other religions believe it is not for everyone. You are chosen for it, you are born for it, or you have to do particular things to get it. In Sikhi, we believe everyone's pregnant with this. Issue is how many of are going to plant it. Very different. So don't let anyone tell you that you have no spiritual capacity or you have no divine potential. Gurbani says every single one person on this earth is born with this. Mantu Jyot Sarupa. Issue is, do you recognize it? And if you recognize it, you plant it, you're going to become an explosive personality. That's how the Naam operates. So it is within reach of every single human being. And in Sikhi, the realization of this is through the Guru's grace. This is what we call Gur Prasad. It is not enough to say, I have everything, or I have done all my work. At some point, this is the idea of hukum essentially, or raza. That you feel that Guru has entered you because you're actually following the instruction of the Guru, which is to alter your behavior. Guru is here to change your behavior. We can't demand from the Guru what to do, but we can definitely demand from ourselves what I need to change in myself. And with that change, you don't know what can happen. Itte mera Punjabi di oh heer jehdi hai, badi famous poetry hai. Somebody asked me once, what's the difference between this my potential and God's, hukum and all that, fundamental questions of life. I said, I don't know, but let me share an answer with you from Ahir. Beautiful poetry in Punjabi. One thing line on the air, Mali dada kam pani dena, o par par mashka paave, us malak da kam falpur nana, o lave paave nana. We are the gardeners. Our job is just to water. If the gardener starts demanding what kind of fruit should come out, what kind of flower should blossom, that's not gardener's job. We are gardeners here. We are here to give water. Keep giving the water. What does the word Simran mean to you? To you? Kisi da na hai ga Simran itthe? Simran means remember God. Thank you, Uncle Ji. Or koi? Anyone else?
Cheta Shakti da Naam.
Cheta Shakti da Naam. Naam phir aa gaya. Can't escape now. What else?
Meditation.
We have to be very careful with the Western terminologies. They carry particular connotation. But generally, both of them are saying meditation. Meditation is a good thing. If you want to go to Gurmani, you can't get it. ਥੋੜਾ ਸੋਚਣਾ ਪਊ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਬਾਰੇ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਨਾ ਗਿਆਨ ਧਿਆਨ ਕਿਛ ਕਰਮ ਨਾ ਜਾਣਾ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਐਨੀਵਨ ਐਲਸ ਵਟ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਯਾ ਕੌਨਸ਼ੀਅਸ ਆਫ ਯੋਰ ਐਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਓਕੇ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਐਕਸਪਲੇਨੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਆਫ ਦਾ ਵਰਡ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਇਜ਼ ਯਾਦ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਸ ਐਂਗਲ ਤੋਂ ਦੇਖਿਓ ਅਗਲੀ ਵਾਰੀ ਜਦ ਪਾਠ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਊੜੈ ਊੜ ਆਵੇ ਸਹਿ ਕੋਸਾ ਹੁਣ ਇਹ ਰਹਿਰਾਸ ਜੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਣ ਵੇਲੇ ਕਰਨ ਵੇਲੇ ਸੋਚਿਓ ਇਹਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਉਡੇ ਉਡ ਆਵੇ ਸਹਿ ਕੋਸਾ ਤਿਸ ਪਾਛੇ ਬਚੜੇ ਛਰਿਆ ਤਿੰਨ ਕਵਣ ਖਲਾਵੇ ਕਵਣ ਚੁਗਾਵੇ ਮਨ ਮੈਂ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰਿਆ ਇੱਕ ਪੰਛੀ ਹੈਗੇ ਦੇ ਫਲਾਇੰਗ ਪੂੰਜਾ ਮਵੀਰ ਦਿਸ ਗਰਲ ਦ ਬਰਡਸ ਆਰ ਫਲਾਇੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਪੇਰੈਂਟਸ ਆਫ ਦ ਬਰਡਸ ਆਰ ਥਿੰਕਿੰਗ ਹੂ ਇਜ਼ ਗੋਨਾ ਫੀਡ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਮਤਲਬ ਮਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਸੋਚ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਰਿਮੈਂਬਰਿੰਗ ਆਈ ਵੰਡਰ ਹਾਊ ਹੂ ਵਿਲ ਫੀਡ ਦੈਮ ਦੇ ਚਿਲਡਰਨ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਇਜ਼ ਯਾਦ ਲੈਟ ਮੀ ਆਸਕ ਯੂ ਗਾਇਜ਼ ਅ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ If you really love somebody, you gonna allow someone else to tell you how to remember them? Basic question. When you are in love, do you ask others? Ki bhai main dasso main kivein yaad karna jida na mera pyar hai. Look where we stand. Simran is yaad. Har bande ne, har janani ne apne tarike naal karni hai. Tahi gurbani ch koi formula nahi hai. You might say Vaheguru, Vaheguru. You might draw something, you might do seva somewhere, you might do kirtan, you might do some readings, you might even meditate, I don't know. All I'm saying is Simran means yaad. Please don't, I think, kisi da bahut changi dosti hove, oh dusra di gal nahi sunda, main onu kivein yaad karda. Oh apne aap figure out karda ki main apne pyare nu kivein yaad karda. Simran is yaad, remembrance. And then Gurbani it says, This shows us that we are not living in remembrance. Guru Nanak Sahib redefines what is living and what is dead. He says, Har bisrat tere gun galaya. When we are in forgetfulness, even the qualities we have, they rot away. And he says, Akha jiva visra par jao. This new way to look at reincarnation also. He says, I die 1,000 times a day. When I'm not remembering, when I don't live in your presence, I'm already dead. When I live in your presence, I am alive. And we feel this too. If you're in love with somebody, I feel like that today, right? Kuch uninspired hai na then. But the inspired away, kehta, man, I can run like a horse, tell me what to do. Because they are in love. They are remembering in their own way. They're inspired. So just nothing else. I mean, Sikh tradition has that Simran has to be full of wisdom. You can do it in with the loved one, it has birha in it has prayers in it has shukrana in it, but you know all this, so I don't want to discuss that. We do all these things. But the part is, how do you do, bada question bane aa rahe, please do it in love, and do it however you like it. It's between you and your guru. Whoever you love, it's the relationship is always between the lover and the beloved. So, tija banda aage, je koi ch tadi vyapari karan karuga, ਟ੍ਰਾਂਜੈਕਸ਼ਨ ਕ੍ਰੀਏਟ ਕਰੂ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਇਹ ਤਰੀਕਾ ਪਿਆਰ ਕਰਨ ਦਾ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਜੁੱਤੀ ਮਾਰੋ ਮਗਰ ਖਿੱਚ ਕੇ ਤੂੰ ਕੌਣ ਉਹਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਦੱਸਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਮੈਂ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਪਿਆਰ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੈ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵਾਟ ਗੁਰੂ ਸੈਡ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਕਾਇੰਡ ਆਫ ਲਾਈਫ ਦੇ ਇਨਸਪਾਇਰਡ ਕਿ ਆਪ ਪਿਆਰ ਕਰੋ ਆਪਣੇ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰੋ ਯਾਰ ਸਾਡੇ ਇੰਸਟੀਟਿਊਸ਼ਨਸ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਸਿਖਾ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਬਟ ਉਹ ਸਿਖਾ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਮੀਨ ਕਿ ਉਹੀ ਤਰੀਕਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਲਈ ਵੀ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਇੰਨੀਆਂ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਸਿਖਾਈਆਂ ਜਾਂਦੀਆਂ ਸੀ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ People do things differently. Oh, Greji di kahawat, we are different strokes for different folks. We are all wired differently. Sare Bachinder Singh thodi bade ne. Kai 52 poet bhi bade si, ohna da tarika si yaad karan da. So don't say ki this is not Sikhi and that's not Sikhi. Out of love, a lot of different dimensions of Sikhi will come out. And that's what I want to move on to. When you are asking how to do Simran, ask yourself, please don't ask anyone else. And the question you need to ask is, Am I doing Simran because I have actually submitted to the Guru, and Guru and Sikhi is both Granth and Panth, and these days nobody is talking about the Panth. We have individual personalities people are submitting to learn how to get Naam. But the Panthic traditions we are forgetting. The other thing we should be asking is, are we really asking out of conviction? Ki mainu Naam mile? Are we really Savdhan Ekagar Chit? Do we have the discipline, as I said earlier, Tartakaya Sadhya Vichdeya Kartavya? Am I body prepared to even take Naam? Because Naam is an active force. If it enters you, you'll be very active. Are you ready to be active? It's not for everyone. That's why they say, be careful what you ask for. Think about it, whether you want Naam in you. Because Naam will make you very active. But I'll give examples of that very soon. And basically, Naam is here to become like Vaheguru. Become like the divine force. The one, if you have Naam in this, then you will be figuring out how to bring people together, not how to dissect them further. Because that's what Ekonkar is. If Ekonkar has entered you, you don't have the other. Even when they hate you, you're figuring out, how do I bring them together? It's tough, of course it's tough, but that's what Naam is. Naam is going to make you actively do that. And I gave example of Baba Jindal Singh Pindrawala yesterday. Regardless of his background, different people answered the call for the Panthic cause. That's Naam. I really believe that's Naam. Where different grades of people, whether they had taken Amrit or not, whether they were keeping here or not, whether they were Taksali or not, they all showed up. That's Naam, bringing people together. So anyway, and the idea of why should I do it, you know why to do it, and I've registered a few things. Did you see ideas can end? Somebody said it earlier, to feel the bliss and to have the joy in your life. All those are the reasons to do it, but the ultimate reason to have Naam in you is to become like Vaheguru. Gurbani talks about all those reasons, the benefits you will have by having Naam, but eventually, you can ask for anything, but the ultimate thing to ask is to become like Vaheguru. So reason we have Naam Simran is to become just like Vaheguru. And if it says in Gurbani, there is no place in Gurbani where it says Vaheguru Badla Lenda. Let me come to realities of these things now. There is no place in Gurbani, in Sikh tradition, where Vaheguru is a vengeful god, or a wrathful god, or a jealous god. But these words exist in other traditions to describe their god. So you better know what kind of god we believe in. Because whatever kind of god you believe in, you will become like that. In our vocabulary, even including in 84 days, we have started saying, Yasi Badla Lena. That is not our tradition. Never was. We have a word in Gurbani called Nyam. That means justice. We fight for justice, not for revenge. They're two very different attitudes. Gurbani has no word called hatred or nafrat. Because we don't entertain that. Because our Vaheguru doesn't hate anyone. In other traditions, they do have gods who don't like some trillion people. There is no hatred in Gurbani. But asi aami kehna ki, I hate this, I hate that. Badi common word ho gaya ajkal. The Gurbani's word is love. It doesn't matter the one who's looking at you, how they look at it. The doctrine of love and justice is huge in Gurbani. So that's why the inspired Sikhs, the people with Naam in their life, they don't talk about hate and revenge. They talk about love and justice. This is our tradition, really. Just do a flashback in history and you'll see this. Asi sodhana word use karta si. Sodhana means to be corrected. But we never said kyon nu marna. There's a difference in attitudes. And we have to really work to develop this attitude. That was the shabad I mentioned earlier. Ki jada sevak banda ho, the attitude kitna na ho jata. We do Naam Simran to bring love in our lives. So we become active agents of justice. Not revenge or hatred. Two very different ideas. So, can I get another volunteer?
Yes.
Haji. Just read it aloud so everyone can hear. I'm just looking for volunteers so I can take a break.
Sikhi is essentially a religion of the way, i.e. something that must be lived and experienced rather than something which may be intellectually grasped and comprehended. True, there can be no practice without the doctrine Sikhi. Therefore, has its doctrines, its views of reality, its views of the nature of humans and their interrelationship, but it lays primary stress on the practice, the discipline.
Thank you. On purpose, I picked this quote, and on purpose, I picked this photograph. This is Sardar Kapoor Singh, this is Baba Jindal Singh Bhindranwale. At Akal Takht. Yep. Now, this man is considered the biggest brain of Sikhs from last century. He studied at Cambridge, when it wasn't as easy to get into Cambridge, like in before Indian independence. I know some of you Cambridge folks are sitting, so I thought I'd throw that in. This guy, if you read his books, you're like, I have no idea what he's saying, because you know they love to show that they went to Cambridge. It's a complicated language. Now, but look at his conclusion. That's why I'm showing this. So he's not an everyday joke. Sardar Kapoor Singh ne pata hove lokan nu kaun sige. He is saying this, Sikhi vich saade bade tareeke ne, saade apne siddhant ne, saade apne paramparavan ne, saade apne traditions ne. But the final thing in Sikhi is, look what he's saying. Has its doctrines, views of reality, views of nature of humans and their interrelationship, but it lays primary stress on the practice. Saada biggest brain of last 100 years is saying, somebody who intellectually understood and wrote about all this, that essentially in Sikhi, once we understand everything, it's about what how you live. So Naam Simran, we can all sit here and try to understand it for 10 more years, and I encourage you to go do that. But once you have understood it, it's about living it. It's important to understand. In faculty, this develop karna, samajna. But samajna is not enough. Otherwise, in today's terminology, it's called, then after we learn only and don't practice, then we will do intellectual gymnastics. Right? Oh, Gurbani sharpshooting messages. Ek line maru, dooja dooji maru, and we'll keep countering each other. Intellectual gymnastics. Primary stress is on living. Now let's talk about those who lived it. Now, this slide, you might find it a little bit funny, but I really feel it. I want to look at, and collectively the Sikh psyche looks at, who are the great Sikhs. And all those movements I'm going to put up here, they're all controversial during their times. Every single movement I'm going to put up here, some of them are still controversial. But to me, if Naam is an active force, if Naam works, you do things, jada Naam jabda, phir tyar ho janda kuch karan layi. This is, if somebody asks me, how do you know there's Naam in you? I'll just say, well, whoever has Naam in them, this is what they do. Because these are the people we remember in Ardas. We don't remember anyone in Ardas, I keep saying it. Not the ones who tried it, not the ones who funded it, not the ones who sympathized with it, but the ones who did it. Those are the only ones we remember collectively. You might remember other people in your homes, but collective Sikh psyche in our Ardas, which is a prayer, before we even begin an Ardas, for the first 4 paragraphs, we go through a simran, a remembrance. Yaad kinu karde hain jinna ne naam japya. Naam japan wale kaun ne ho, main think list karan lag gaya. Just keep this in mind. The 5th paragraph starts with an ardaas. Prithme sarvat khalsa ji ki ardaas hai ji. Before that, we are remembering those who did it. And let's talk about them. And I'm not going to cover the gurus. Let me actually put this slide up. This is the history of people who did things. You might disagree with them. You might not like some of them. But guess what? They are the ones who did it. And they were all controversial people. Khalsa Raj ne established ki tha, bande bahadur hunde si chhad de. But I can guarantee you, nobody was an eyewitness to what happened between him and Banda Singh Bahadur when he was Madhav Das Bairagi. That's why Naam is between a Sikh and the Guru. But we know what that Naam did. That Naam destroyed the largest dynasty of South Asia. He fought with the corrupt leaders. You know about the Buddha Alankar Nagar. When there is nobody there to defend Sikhi, whatever we might say about the Dehangs today, but the Dehangs of those days, they are the ones who did it. And you know, it was very simple formula, I mean, approach. If you are below 40, you are Tarnadal. If you are above 40, you are Buddhadal. Implementer should be Tarnadal. Planner should be Buddhadal. So we need everyone. Those who have experience, go plan things for us. If you have less experience, become the foot soldier. Problem today is everyone wants to be a general. Nobody wants to be a foot soldier in Guru Nanak's revolution. And Guru Nanak's revolution was all about having whoever was a good foot soldier, Panth recognized them and they used to say, you are the leader. This is Nawab Kapoor Singh for us. He was a foot soldier. So foot soldiers were the ones who were encouraged to go into the generalship, to use the military analogy. And you know these people. Yes, in all of these periods there are people who we might not like. Contemporary accounts show that as well. Even Ranjit Singh period, we only remember Ranjit Singh. Why would we remember Akhandi Phula Singh at a better level? That's Ranjit Singh period. And even in Khalsa Raj or the Sikh Raj during Ranjit Singh, what about Nalwa? In 1833, he writes a letter to Ranjit Singh. He says, you have made the biggest mistake of your life. For the first time in Sikh nation, you have chosen a successor individually. He said, we made you our chief. The Khalsa, he writes, made you the chief. He says, Khadak Singh is my son, but he's not the right successor. Janda asi apne puttan nu dekh aunde aaj vi dekh lo ki ho reha Punjab ch. Oh kehnda vi hai baat. You might like him or not, but he says, I'm bringing Ranjit Singh Raj back. He's absolutely right. He's corrupting everything and making sure his son rules. From a Sikh angle. Ranjit Singh did a lot of great things too, pluralistic models, other things, but from a Sikh angle, he's only bringing the negativity of Ranjit Singh, not the positivity of Ranjit Singh, that he actually figured out how to create a multicultural, multi-pluralistic models. Anyway, coming back to it, now let me focus on Gaddar Lahar a bit. You know, 100 years ago, when Sikhs in diaspora supported Indian independence movement by money and by their time, it was okay. But when Sikhs did this 20 years ago, somehow it became more controversial. I went to Stockton 3 weeks ago. It's the 100th anniversary of that Gurdwara this year. The first Gurdwara in North America, in America. I was going through their archives. I found their original documents of when the Gurdwara started in Stockton in 1911. That's the anniversary year. 100 years ago. So something for our Gurdwaras to note if you're interested in this. The first secretary of that Gurdwara, look at his vision. In 30 years later, he became the first member of Congress, South Asian member of Congress in America, Daleep Singh Song. He was the secretary of that Gurdwara. I looked at the funding, Gurdwara ji funding ki galla hundi hai na. I go, let me find out how did they fund things. Amazing stuff. They had a Shaheed Fund, 1910. They had Indian Independence Fund. Jawaharlal Nehru's sister came there in 1911. Sikhs gave, that Gurdwara gave $6,000 in those days. Go spend to free people in India. This is our tradition. We want to continue it. We should be continuing it everywhere in the world. Jithe bhi freedom loving bande rehte hain. But because we don't know our traditions, kasi ko raja nahi hai, ki fund ho gaya. Well, Gaddar Lahar did this. Punjabi Super Lahar, you know. Khadku Lahar, I'm calling it, because that's what happened. People were fighting to get rid of enslavement, and I covered more of that last night. Now, you might say, how do I know we did Namche? Well, every movement has people who are going to be there to take advantage. You think Banda Singh Bahadur didn't have those with him? They were there. You didn't think Sikh Raj didn't have it? Of course they were there. They sold us out even. After we won Battle of Chiniyawala, even then they sold us out. Sellouts are always there. In America, we call them house Negroes. We all have them. Every community has them. But when you tell your narrative, you don't focus on them. You focus on those who did it. So that's noise. Don't get distracted by noise of how certain Khadkus were bad. I want to focus on the ones who were good. Yeah, even in Guru period, there were certain Guru sons who were bad too. But do we focus on them? Choose your narrative very carefully. Apni dastan aap sunao. And you have to figure out which narrative. And our narrative is Sunday jide tak, you know, people say the movement last 20 years was anpadhyala siga. Well, I think the guy who is a leader, a doctor, a medical doctor who runs a PGI, he's a director there, if he's a panthik committee chairman, I don't think he's anpad. We might disagree with his politics, but don't say ki anpad run kar desi. In a noise create kar rahe. Understand the facts, what was happening in those days. Lot of them were Amritdhari Sikhs, lot of them were college students, lot of them didn't even keep their case. But they believed in this idea that whatever the Sikh practices from day one, let's continue it. Fight for the freedom. I'll move on. Question is, what can I do? I'm on the last slide. If you're getting bored, then we'll open it up for question and answer. If you are in kindergarten, you say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, till Z or Z here. If you're in fifth grade, if you're still doing that, and let's say you're in 11th grade, you're still doing that, what would we say to you? Don't answer that, just think about it. We learn the alphabets, Punjabi jada joke bhi hai, jo ji 10th pakki kar rahe hai, jo baar baar hote rahe. But the point is, you're not developing. We learn, Professor Puran Singh writes beautifully, he says, we learn the alphabets so we can learn to make the words. We make the words so we can learn to make the sentences. We learn the sentences so we can learn to communicate. Whatever you are doing, however you do Simran, however you have Naam entering within you, if it is not helping you to communicate with Vaheguru, either what you are doing is not right or how you are doing is not right. You gotta have conversations with God, and Neil Donald Walsh might say. Je gall hi nahi ho rahi pyare naal, fir tusi eh nahi keh sakde. I refuse to say ki Naam galat hai, kyunki gurbani bandi hai, theek hai. So ekko hi option rahegi fir, ki jo tusi kar rahe ho, ohde vich kuch evaluate karo. It's about your intention. Don't try to evaluate, oh, kitna jab rahe. That's what we do. Why do you worry about it? Figure out, how do I need to do it? Harek da vakhra tarika hoga. Asi kyon onu condemn karde hain jehda Vaheguru bol reha ya jehda nahi bol reha. Issue is ki main kivein bolna. Main Rab de naal, Guru de naal kivein gallan karniyan ne. Main is level de kivein pyar karan ki Guru mere ghar aave, mainu mile aake. That's how Gurbani writes it. That Guru needs to walk into my house. It's not that I'm gonna go there. Look at the level. In fact, if you read the classic love stories, that's how it works. The one you love, you're gonna love them so intensely, they have no option but to come to your house. Yeah, that's Punjabi poetry too, if you listen carefully to it. And that's Gurbani. Inna jabardast, and actually option rehndi nahi hai, azma ke bhi dekh leo. Anyway. Communication is what Naam Simran is also. This is the way we are doing it. We generally do it. We are doing it all the time. When you are listening to Sharda, I am listening to my girl, I am going to go. And this is what happens mostly, right? And sometimes I wonder, we are doing it all the time. We are going to go to the end. We are going to remember the whole day. We are going to remember the whole day. We are going to say something wrong. We are going to say something wrong. We are going to auntie ji da e wala suit si ga oh hun india to aayi honi ya aur observation sada lens se hi hai na is vele all sorts of noises are there hukum ki aaya si ardaas to baad nahi yaad rehnda. Now let me present it differently. If somebody is speaking all the time in your life and they never stop and listen to you, what do we think of that? Kehne yaar woh dur dekhne yaar dur ho gaya ve shada chada hun main soch reha Guru Ji bhi saade ko dekhte honge, unhe 4 ghante laake, inda jor laake gal kari hai ki sikhi ki hai. Hun hukum ja sunaya hai, sunaya hai. So think about it. We just keep talking to the Guru or the Vaheguru. We don't take time not to listen. Mande pe sunaya di gal utthe hai ki Abji sahab tusi aap dekh rahe ho. Take time out to listen to what the Simran is asking you to do. Simran is active force, Naam is active force, you have to change it. Dusri gal, jide vich naam aa janda, oh sikhi di vadiyai nahi karda, oh sikhi apni zindagi vich lae aunda. And if we keep boasting about sikhi, it means we don't know what sikhi is in our own lives. That's what's happening. We keep saying how great the Sikhs were. I mean, I'm American and I'm a Jeffersonian, and Thomas Jefferson, and sorry, Abraham Lincoln used to say, one of the presidents there, he says, stop bragging about what your grandfather did. and start worrying about what your grandson is up to. ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਵੱਡਿਆਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਰੋਟੀਆਂ ਖਾਈ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਸਿੱਖੀ ਦੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨਿਆਣੇ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਜਾਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਉਸ ਪਤਾ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਆਏ ਦੱਸ ਰਿਹਾ ਨਾ ਜੀ ਦੱਸ ਵਾਈ ਨੂੰ ਵਾਈ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਦੇ ਦੱਸ ਦੇ ਸੀ ਵਟ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਵਟ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਦੇ ਲਾਈਕ ਹੀ ਇਸ ਫੁੱਲ ਆਫ ਇਟ ਦੱਸ ਵੀ ਸੇ ਲੈਟਸ ਬੀ ਰੀਅਲ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਦੇ ਡੋਨਟ ਸੀ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦੋਸ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਟਸ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਆਨੈਸਟ ਆਈ ਗਰੂ ਅਪ ਇਨ ਕੈਂਸਰ ਸਿਟੀ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਯੂਜ਼ ਟੂ ਥਿੰਕ ਯਾਰ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਸਿੱਖਾਂ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਹੈ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਹੋ ਕਿਤੇ ਐਵੇਂ ਨਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਬਣਾਈ ਜਾਂਦੇ Stop boasting about Sikhi, internalize the message of Sikhi, that's Naam. Naam is internal, you can't see it, externalization will be what you do with it. Third thing, powerful ideas are the ones you don't talk about but you live with them. Je ajay bhi mainu kehna peh reha ki janani is equal in Sikhi, that's not a powerful idea. It was a powerful idea 500 years ago. Today the powerful idea will be we work our asses off to make sure women do get equitable positions in the society. Seriously. Guru Amar Das Pasha ne karta si. Imagine the kind of level of opposition he had where you know what happens in Afghanistan even today. He's only 50 miles from there. And you know what happens in cow belt of India. He's not that far away from there. In that superstructure, he says, no, women will also lead our religious institutions. And he establishes 3 manjis for them out of 22. So powerful idea is not the one we keep talking about. I want to see it in practice today. That's powerful. Jo nahi dikh rahe na reality de vich oh powerful nahi hai oh fir sloganeering hai which we are all good at. Fourth thing, change your thoughts. Thoughts change emotions and emotions change actions. One of the leading educators in the world is Edward de Bono. I love what he writes because he's talking about how do we make people understand things. And this is what he has written. He says, don't try to change emotions with logic. This is what we do these days. ਇੱਕ ਮੁੰਡੇ ਨੇ ਕੁੜੀ ਨਾਲ ਵਿਆਹ ਕਰਾਉਣਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਲੌਜਿਕ ਦੇਈ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹ ਤੇਰੇ ਲਈ ਠੀਕ ਨਹੀਂ ਉਹਦੇ ਮਾਪੇ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਉਹ ਘੱਟ ਪੈਸੇ ਬਣਾਉਂਦਾ ਲੌਜਿਕ ਤੇ ਲੌਜਿਕ ਉਹ ਸੁਣਦੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਗੱਲ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਯਾਰ ਸ਼ਿਟ ਵਾਟ ਆਰ ਯੂ ਸੇਇੰਗ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਵਾਟ ਐਡਵਰਟ ਡੀਬੋਨੋ ਸੇਜ਼ ਹੀ ਸੇਜ਼ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਚੇਂਜ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਸ ਚੇਂਜ ਪਰਸੈਪਸ਼ਨਸ ਦੇਖਣ ਦਾ ਨਜ਼ਰੀਆ ਬਦਲੋ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਸ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋ ਜਾਣਗੇ ਦੈਟਸ ਵਾਟ ਗੁਰੂ ਸੇ ਦੇ ਡਿਵੈਲਪ ਦ ਨਿਊ ਲੈਂਸ ਫੋਰ ਅਸ ਟੂ ਲੁੱਕ ਐਟ ਇਹ ਨੇਤਰੋਂ ਮੇਰੇ ਹੋ ਹਰ ਬਿਨ ਅਵਰ ਨਾ ਦੇਖੋ ਕੋਈ ਅ ਨਿਊ ਲੈਂਸ ਵਾਸ ਡਿਵੈਲਪ ਅ ਨਿਊ ਥਾਟ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸ ਵਾਸ ਡਿਵੈਲਪ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਚੇਂਜ ਯੋਰ ਥਾਟ ਯੋਰ ਐਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਵਿਲ ਚੇਂਜ ਯੋਰ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਸ ਵਿਲ ਚੇਂਜ ਡੋਂਟ ਟ੍ਰਾਈ ਟੂ ਚੇਂਜ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਸ ਵਿਦ ਲੌਜਿਕ ਇਟ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਵਰਕ ਐਵਰੀ ਸਾਈਕੋਲੋਜਿਸਟ ਕੈਨ ਟੈਲ ਯੂ ਦੈਟ ਐਂਡ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਲਿਟਮਸ ਟੈਸਟ ਦੋਜ਼ ਹੂ ਹੈਵ ਨਾਮ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਇਨ ਦੇਅਰ ਲਾਈਵਸ ਦੇ ਹੈਵ ਜ਼ੀਰੋ ਟੋਲਰੈਂਸ ਫੋਰ ਰੇਸ ਐਂਡ ਜੈਂਡਰ ਬਾਇਸ If you say you have Naam and you haven't figured out how to treat a human being with dignity and with respect, I'm sorry, something else is operating in you. Because in Sikhi, Naam equals Vaheguru. Vaheguru is a Jyoti. Vaheguru believes in dignity of every human being, even the ones who don't believe in God. That's very important here. ਆਪਣਾ ਬੰਦਾ ਘਬਰਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਜੀ ਨਾਸਤਿਕ ਆ ਗਏ ਆਈਥੀਸਟ ਨੇ ਜਾਂ ਕਾਮਰੇਡ ਨੇ ਕਿਉਂ ਘਬਰਾਉਂਦੇ ਹੋ That's their choice. Are you able to treat them equally? There is no place in Guru Granth Sahib where it says, ਇੱਕ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਆਉਂਦਾ how to rule in this world. ਉੱਥੇ ਕਹਿ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਰੱਬ ਕੋਲੋਂ ਸਿੱਖੋ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਰੂਲ ਕਰਨਾ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੀ ਮੰਨਦਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਹਵਾ ਦੇ ਰਿਹਾ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਮਰੇ ਨਾ This is Sikhi. Zero tolerance for race and gender bias. And those are pretty much all the biases in the world. ਉਹ ਦੇਖਣ ਨੂੰ ਮੇਰੇ ਵਰਗਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਉਹ ਜਨਾਨੀ ਦੀ ਕਪੈਸਿਟੀ ਹੈ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੁਛ ਇਹੋ ਜਿਹੀਆਂ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਆਲ ਦ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਆਈ ਡੋਨਟ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਗੈਟ ਇਨਟੂ ਇਟ ਐਂਡ ਡੋਨਟ ਜਸਟ ਬੀ ਅ ਸੰਡੇ ਸਿੱਖ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਵਟ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਡਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਕੰਪਾਰਟਮੈਂਟਲਾਈਜ਼ ਸਿੱਖੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਕ ਘੰਟਾ ਬਹਿ ਕੇ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰ ਲਾਂਗੇ ਉਹ ਜੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਫਿਸ ਦੇ ਡੈਸਕ ਤੇ ਬੈਠੇ ਹਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਡਿਸੀਜਨ ਗਲਤ ਲੈਣ ਵੇਲੇ 2 ਮਿੰਟ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੋਚਦੇ ਦੈਟਸ ਕੰਪਾਰਟਮੈਂਟਲਾਈਜ਼ੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੈਟਸ ਕਾਲਡ ਇਟਸ ਨਾਟ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਇਟਸ ਮਕੈਨੀਕਲ ਸਾਧਨਾ It was supposed to change my behavior. If I have done 2 hours of part today and I've gone home and abused my wife, that's not Simran. That's something else. Because you have already forgotten what you were remembering. So compartmentalized living is not Naam Simran. It has to be daily change in behavior. Basically, when habitually you start doing divine things, you have Naam Simran in you. No more effort. You have changed so much that you have become Vaheguru-like. That's Naam Simran. And the only way to have Simran in your life is to do it with love. That's the only categorical statement I can find in Gurbani. Jin prem kiyo tini prapayo, you know the line. And kiyo is the operative, those who attended Grastha have focused on that. It doesn't say jin prem filo. We all feel the prem. It says those who do it with love, not those who have the feeling of love only. Do pakhne cheezan hai. We all have good feelings, but we don't do it with love. We do it with feelings of love. Feeling is important. Make sure whatever you are doing is loving devotion. Prem to bagair gal nahi bad sakdi, ye baar baar gurbani cha chukya aayega. You have to become the lover. Lover beyond consequences. That's the way to bring Simran in your life. And don't worry about what people are saying. We worry way too much about them. We keep saying ki yaar meri sass ki sochugi te mere gyani ji ki sochange. That's the reality, right? Oh yaar main jathe vich vi beh jaanda ja ke oh kehnge ajj sade vang nahi kita. Main taksaliyan kol vi kal gaya si but main unna di gal vi nahi manni. Those are all learning centers. How missionaries do it, how Baba Ji does it, how Nanak Sariyas do it. Don't worry too much about it. Everyone has to figure out how you need to do it. Because in Gurbani it says, if somebody is forcing you to do a particular way, Bhatta Chatti, that's the word in Gurbani. Je kare, in out of compulsion if you do something, it's never good. Bada clearly likha hai. Don't do. How can you be religious out of compulsion? It sounds horrible. Can you love out of compulsion? It's horrible. In fact, those things usually end up in divorces or abuse situations. Hence, Gurbani is so clear about this. Okay, they don't do anything in compulsion. Kivein karo phir? Prem ki paasha vich. Baar baar hi aa gaya. There is no other alternative. You gotta do it in love. And in fact, Gurbani goes on to say, any custom which forces you to do things, which takes you away from your love, burn it away. Jalo aisi reed jit mein pyara visare. Burn away those customs which take you away from your beloved. This is a very revolutionary thought. This is not asking you to remain status quo. It's asking you to become basically what we generally today in romantic sense say, fall in love. It is actually asking you to fall in love. People who are in love, they are in cloud nine. They don't care what the world thinks. Same thing with the Guru. The ones who are in love with Guru, they don't think what the world thinks. That's how Naam Simran works. And this is the last thing. If you choose to follow the Khalsa lifestyle, the Naam Simran essentially says, you are not a subordinate of anyone. Khalsa da meaning hi hai ga, jada sovereign hai ga. If you are not free, and you say you are part of the Khalsa nation, Khalsa commonwealth, Khalsa Panth, something is wrong. Khalsa means sovereign. You are not subordinate of anyone. Tu si kise de thalle nahi ho. He wrote a book called From Peshawar to Calcutta. And he says, I'm walking around in India, I can't find any free man. Suddenly a man on the horse comes near me, I'm paraphrasing. And he says, I ask him, who's your boss? And this man looks at me, he says, boss, we don't have bosses. I report directly to God. He said, this was the first free man I found in India, and he was a Sikh. ਇਹ ਹੈ ਸਾਡੀ ਹਿਸਟਰੀ ਹੁਣ ਸਾਡੇ ਬੌਸ ਹੀ ਬੜੇ ਹੋ ਗਏ ਕਿਹਦੀ ਕਿਹਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਮੰਨੋਗੇ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਆ ਗਿਆ ਨਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਲੈਸ ਨੇ ਟੁਡੇ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਰਾਈਡਿੰਗ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਵਿਦ ਆਰ ਲੈਸ ਨੇ ਆਈ ਫਾਈਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਫਨੀ ਟੂ ਖਾਲਸਾ ਇਜ਼ ਨਾਟ ਐਨ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਕਲੈਕਟਿਵ ਇਟ ਨੈਵਰ ਵਾਸ ਐਨ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ ਇਟਸ ਆਲਵੇਸ ਬੀਨ ਅ ਕਲੈਕਟਿਵ ਉੱਥੇ ਲਿਖਿਆ ਇਨ ਹੀ ਕੀ ਕਿਰਪਾ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਪਲੂਰਲ Khalsa is when you and all of us, when we decide to give our allegiance to the Guru and we say we are free people, that's a Khalsa. Badi different gal hai ya. Kalla amrat chak ke gurdware da pradhan banna is not Khalsa. This is happening. I don't know ithe hoya ki nahi, but kai thaan ho reha. Doesn't matter. Khalsa is jagan jyot. Khalsa is drenched in love. Khalsa is not believing in fastings. Khalsa is continuously working on yourself, that behavior change. So this is where I will leave it. That Naam is basically identification. We have a culture of Naam. in this culture, everything is Naam, which helps us get closer to our love. ਪਿਆਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਬੰਦਾ ਭੱਜਿਆ ਜਾਵੇ ਉਹ ਨਾਮ ਆ। ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਇਹ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਬਾਹਰ ਮੀਂਹ ਪੈ ਰਿਹਾ, ਲੋਕੀ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਵੈਦਰ ਖਰਾਬ ਆ, ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਪਿਆਰ ਹੋਵੇ ਨਾ ਵਰਲਡਲੀ ਲੈਵਲ ਤੇ, ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਰੋਕੋ ਕੋਈ ਸਨੋਅ ਪੈ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਨਾ ਜਾ, ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਜਾਣਾ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਚਾਹ ਚੜਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ। ਇਹੀ ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਚ ਲਿਖਿਆ, ਭਿੱਜੋ ਸਿੱਜੋ ਕੰਬਲੀ ਅੱਲਾ ਵਰਸੇ ਮੇ ਹੋ, ਜਾਏ ਮਿਲਾ ਤੇ ਨਾ ਸੱਜਣਾ ਟੁੱਟੇ ਨਾ ਹੀ ਨੇ, ਮਾਈ ਲਵ ਮਸਟ ਨਾਟ ਡਿਮਿਨਿਸ਼, ਆਈ ਬੈਟਰ ਰਨ, ਆਈ ਡੋਂਟ ਕੇਅਰ ਵਾਟ ਦਾ ਵੈਦਰ ਇਜ਼। ਗੁਰਬਾਣੀ ਚੱਖਣ ਝਾਂਗੀ ਮੀਂਹ ਵਰਸੈ ਫੀ ਗੁਰ ਦੇਖਣ ਜਾਏ। ਚੱਖਣ ਸਾਡੇ ਦਿਮਾਗਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਨੇ, ਬਾਹਰ ਘੱਟ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ, ਗਲੋਬਲ ਵਾਰਮਿੰਗ ਕਰਕੇ ਵੈਸੇ ਬੜਾ ਕੁਛ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ, ਬਟ ਸਾਡੇ ਦਿਮਾਗ ਦਾ ਚੱਖਣ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੱਲ ਰਿਹਾ। ਵੀ ਆਰ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਅਪ ਐਂਡ ਡਾਊਨ, ਮੂੜੀ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਬਹੁਤ, ਐਂਡ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਇੰਟਰਨਲ ਵੈਦਰ। ਐਂਡ ਗੁਰੂ ਅਰਜਨ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਇਜ਼ ਸੇਇੰਗ ਇਟ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਮੈਟਰ ਇਫ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਹਰੀਕੇਨ ਇਨ ਯੋਰ ਮਾਈਂਡ, ਇਟ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਮੈਟਰ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਅ ਸਨੋ ਸਟੋਰਮ ਇਨ ਯੋਰ ਮਾਈਂਡ, make sure you go to your guru to ask what to do. This is Naam Simran. This is a continuous journey of a Sikh. Basically, it creates a divine culture, and that culture, and I leave it with this and open up to Q&A, this culture is supposed to make us free. Naam is supposed to make us free, not make it more hindrance for us. Je oh bandhan hor create kar rahe ho, naam ho hi nahi sakda. ਨਾਮ ਨੇ ਤਾਂ ਬੰਧਨ ਤੋੜਨੇ ਨੇ, ਇਹਦੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਤੋੜੇ ਬੰਧਨਾ। ਵੀ ਸਪੋਜ਼ ਟੂ ਫਰੀ ਅਰਸੈਲਵਸ, ਨਾਮ ਇਜ਼ ਸਪੋਜ਼ ਟੂ ਫਰੀ ਅਸ, ਨਾਟ ਕਨਫਾਈਨ ਅਸ। ਸੋ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਨਾਮ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟਿਸਿੰਗ, ਇਟਸ ਅ ਰੈਟੋਰੀਕਲ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਯੂ ਆਸਕ, ਆਨਸਰ ਇਟ ਯੋਰਸੈਲਫ, ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਫਰੀ, ਔਰ ਆਲਸੋ ਇਜ਼ ਦਿਸ ਦਸ ਵਟ ਐਵਰ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਡੂਇੰਗ, ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਅ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਸਿਮਰਨ, ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਗੋ ਡੂ ਥਿੰਕ ਡੂ ਥਿੰਗਸ, ਆਰ ਯੂ ਰੈਡੀ ਟੂ ਆਨਸਰ ਦ ਕਾਲਸ ਬੇਸਿਕਲੀ। ਜਿਹੜਾ ਬੰਦਾ ਨਾਮ ਜਪਦਾ ਤੇ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰਦਾ, ਦੇ ਪ੍ਰਪੇਅਰ ਦੈਮਸੈਲਵਸ ਟੂ ਟੇਕ ਔਨ ਇਸ਼ੂਜ਼ ਇਨ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ। ਅਰਦਾਸ ਦੇ ਐਂਡ ਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜੋ ਬੋਲੇ, ਵੈਸੇ ਜੋ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਬੰਦ ਕਰਤਾ, ਸੋ ਨਿਹਾਲ ਸਤਿ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ ਇਜ਼ ਦੀ ਆਨਸਰ। ਉਹਦਾ ਮੀਨਿੰਗ ਇਹ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਸੀਗਾ, ਵਟ ਐਵਰ ਯੂ ਹਰਡ ਸੋ ਫਾਰ, ਇਫ ਯੂ ਆਨਸਰ ਦਿਸ ਕਾਲ, ਆਨਸਰਿੰਗ ਦਿਸ ਕਾਲ ਇਜ਼ ਆਨਸਰਿੰਗ ਦ ਕਾਲ ਆਫ ਡਿਸਟ੍ਰੈਸਡ ਪੀਪਲ, ਵਿਚ ਮੀਨਸ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਰੈਡੀ ਟੂ ਗੋ ਟੇਕ ਔਨ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ। ਹੁਣ ਸਾਡੀ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਦੀ ਸਲੋਗਨੀਅਰਿੰਗ ਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ, ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਪਤਾ। ਹੁਣ ਅਕਾਲ ਤਖ਼ਤ ਤੇ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਇੱਕ ਰੇਪ ਵਿਕਟਮ ਕਹਿੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਆਫਿਸਰ ਨੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਕੀਤਾ ਰੇਪ, ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ। ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਸੋਸ਼ਲ ਰਿਐਲਿਟੀ ਟੁਡੇ, ਯਾ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਓਨਲੀ ਹੈਪਨ 4 ਇਅਰਸ ਅਗੋ, ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਨਾਮ ਇਜ਼ ਨਾਟ ਐਨ ਐਕਟਿਵ ਫੋਰਸ ਐਨੀਮੋਰ। ਨਾਮ ਇਜ਼ ਐਨ ਐਕਟਿਵ ਫੋਰਸ, ਵਿਚ ਬੇਸਿਕਲੀ ਮੀਨਸ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨਾਟ ਪ੍ਰੈਕਟਿਸਿੰਗ ਨਾਮ, we are not practicing simran, there is no formula of this, this is between you and your guru, make sure you figure it out in love, you will know what to do, because people in love don't need instructions, they just need to talk to their beloved. Vaheguru ji ka khalsa, Vaheguru ji ki fateh.